And that button probably means we're live. So welcome everybody back. Sorry for the late start. We got getting ready started late because of the debate, and then, you know, everything cascades and nothing starts when you like it to.
There was a fight with a lava monster. It was crazy, and yeah. You missed it.
All gone. It's never gonna happen again.
So. All right. So let me just close this tab real quick over here.
I have a face now.
Ta-da! Yes, you guys can all now see Alex.
Oh, God.
No longer the mystery voice from behind the curtain.
And so now we'll jump right into episode 3. So to recap last time, I'm going to do a recap of our first two episodes. So in our first, it's less written down this time. So in our first episode, our party met in the town of Redlark. Well, almost all of our party, the first four members of our party here. Luna Gladwell, who'd been staying in the town for about a week or so. Pharaoh, Reese, and Salik, who had all come into town fairly recently. Pharaoh and Reese met each other on the way into town. Salik was sleeping on the roof of the inn of the town as an Arakokra. He had his little nest going. They met there, had some shenanigans, go watch episode 1, and decided to go out into the nearby Sumber Hills to investigate strange goings-on. There were recently been some earthquakes, some, you know, weird mists, other sorts of strange elemental energy going on. In addition, a delegation from the northern city of Mirabar was supposed to come down through the Deseran Valley here, and they were last seen in the town of Beliard, where they disappeared after leaving that town, and had not been seen since. So our party ventured north, got in a couple fights, bumped into the Eldris brothers, Blacksmith brothers, Theo and Aridin. Alex, correct
Aridin.
Me. Aridin,
was that
the first time?
Yeah, you said it right.
All right, cool. Every time I look, I question myself. Bumped into the Blacksmith brothers, who had been sent by the town's mayor to Beliard to go investigate the delegation. As a party of six, they headed to the town and heard that the town had been there, and from there the delegation had headed south. And so the party headed south after the delegation, and found the remains of a battle. They found several Mirabaran soldiers, warriors, dead, that had been dead for what could be a week, but could be less. There was some strange magical energy around it. From there, they headed west towards a tower that they saw in the distance. And on the way, they were attacked by some people in blue armor and cloaks, riding on large vultures.
Giant vultures.
That vulture
blocked out the sun.
And are now continuing to head towards the tower.
Indeed.
Did I leave anything important out?
Blocked out the sun.
Ladies and gentlemen.
We followed the trail of whatever the battle was,
yes.
Where we found the bodies, until it went to the river and it went cold.
Correct.
Because river.
All right.
Just wanted to say we did our due diligence with the tracking.
All right, and real quick.
Do you see the tower yet? Is it in view?
It's in the distance.
It's in the distance. You guys have been able to see it over the tops of the hills.
It's kind of far. We have to walk.
And
it's
gonna
pretty tough terrain.
Bring up for just a moment. Right here we have. Uh oh.
Ooh.
There it goes. Took a second to load. The map of the Deseran Valley. So this is where we are. So if you look in the, I can't really point here, but on the left side of the map, we have the town of Redlark along that thick red line that is the long road. On the opposite side of the Sumber Hills of Redlark is the town of Beliard. And they have traveled south along that road, the Deseran Road, then cut west along that road and have crossed the river and are now somewhere in the South Sumber Hills.
Where's the tower on this map?
Somewhere in the South Sumber Hills.
Cool.
Ooh,
got it.
A little bit lost. Not a big deal.
All right.
Not super lost.
Don't bite me.
We got on top of one of the really big hills. We might be able to see better.
That is true. I believe the tower is on top.
My brother is a wise man. Well.
So
really
you guys,
big hills are kind of like towers.
I already looked around pretty much everywhere. So. I think this is just about what we have, and we should see where this leads.
Cool. So you guys are have traveled through here, past this canyon, around this area, and all these things, and you are now approaching the tower. You can see it in the distance, in the foreground. The spire rises from a pillar of rock high into the air, the tallest point for miles. Built from white limestone and embellished in marble, the spire resembles a gleaming sword that pierces the sky. The gatehouse faces the opposite cliff, its drawbridge the only apparent point of entry. Tall, wide windows encompass the bottom level of the tower, absent only upon the gatehouse side. A circle of open stalls rings the tower's foundation, where it meets the rock. Above each stall, the sculpture of a hippogriff in flight leaps from the tower's base. Beneath Feathergale Spire, to the east, a wide, gusty canyon yawns through the hills.
Okay, so we have a valley and a valley, right? That's what's going on.
Yeah, so I'm gonna pull up a picture here of the spire for you guys just for a minute so you can take a look. It might take a second to load here. Here we go. So there's a bunch of rooms and things here. So if you look on the left side here, we're on the ground level area. You can see that there's some rock coming out of the ground right at the edge of this valley, and the drawbridge connects across this gap of canyon over to the ground level.
Got it.
So the...
Yeah, there's windows like along the bottom floor, but not where the drawbridge is. That's what I heard.
To show you another picture that will help give you guys some context for how this looks, there's this valley
here. Wait,
it's
sighing? I thought it was yawning.
There's
I thought it was stretching.
There's
no, that's me.
There's a valley here you can see, and the river run, and there's some river running through the valley. And if you look at the top left there, that's the spire. It sticks up on this, jutting up on this rock. Against the edge of this valley, and you guys, because you've come from the north, have come over the around the top of this valley to approach Feathergale Spire.
Oh, good, a manticore lair like 3,000 feet from us. That's awesome.
It's pretty.
They have to have a lair somewhere, okay? Everybody needs a home.
Manticore.
Let's not be judgy.
But it's like a mile and a half that way.
Just don't go that way, especially without announcing yourself. Don't trespass. It's bad.
What if right it's
now,
going
I'm more worried about griffins and vultures than manticores, but maybe I am faulty in this.
Dudes in blue armor with billowing white capes.
Blocking out the sun.
Oh, my.
Exactly.
Well, should we approach the gatehouse, or should we hang back and observe for a while?
Is the drawbridge down?
Pardon?
Is the drawbridge down?
Here, I will describe. A gap of 20 feet separates the ledge where the path ends from the closed drawbridge on the spire.
Okay.
The space between the cliff's edge and the gatehouse drops several hundred feet to the bottom of the canyon. Near the ledge, a brass bell hangs from a wooden post.
Oh, it's the doorbell.
Is the bell out of order? Please knock, because the door is really far away. Hopefully the bell works.
I start, rummaging through my pack and I don't think I have anything that can help us get across that bridge.
Hey, Aaron, ring the bell.
Okay.
Cool.
I ring the bell.
Wait. That sounds like a bad idea.
I already rung it.
How would you announce yourself to a civilized person, especially a guild member?
A small window near the gate opens up, and a woman leans out. She's in blue armor. Leans out and says, "Welcome to Feathergale Spire. What brings you here?"
Salted pork delivery.
Excuse me.
No, we're looking. So, just to be clear, so I know what's happening, out of character, we're here because we heard that this is where the delegation went, right?
We're here because we saw the dead bodies of a lot of members of the delegation and people were missing, and this wasn't big enough
for a ride.
Yeah, you guys
okay,
are
then we should just say that.
Well, okay, wait. Out of character. We didn't see dead bodies of the delegation. We saw dead bodies of people that the delegation hired to protect their caravan. We didn't...
Who were seen with them and still wearing the armor they wore.
But we didn't unbury the cairn, so we don't actually know if they were in there or not. But we are here to get news.
In a cairn.
Dead bodies. It's rocks around dead bodies, yeah, like a big mound made of rocks.
It's like you dig a small hole, you put some dudes in it, you cover it in rocks. That's
you don't even have to dig a hole. You can just leave the bodies there and put the rocks around it.
I thought that was something completely different because the cairn in my life is always like nine rocks on top of each other.
Yeah, that is also a thing. That was my first thought too, but then everyone was saying, well, let's dig up the body. I was like, oh, there's a body in there. Okay.
Yeah.
So there's a body in there, and we didn't dig it up.
We did not.
No, we're not grave robbers.
The cleric wanted to, and the warlock didn't for some reason.
It's a weird, morally ambiguous situation.
That is classist.
Grave investigators.
So listen to me, I'm just a fighter.
So I think what we're doing is going here, and GM, you can jump in at any time, but I think what we're doing is going here to be like, what news from the mock? And like, what have they heard of the delegation? Because we saw some weird shit. Did they see weird shit? Wait, is she in blue armor with a white billowing cape?
You see blue armor.
Is she attractive? More important.
You know, yeah.
The typical
I think we
question.
Should roll.
She's not like,
10.
She's not super attractive. She's a, you know, but she's...
I roll to seduce her.
Sharp features, but...
Yeah, can Aaron roll to seduce her?
Oh, no, I was speaking from you.
No, you should totally do it.
No, go ahead, bro.
Thanks, man.
It's your turn.
I'll dibs.
All right. It's your turn.
I don't recall any order of pork.
Wait, how do I roll seduce? Is it persuasion?
It's charisma, because everything's just...
It would be persuasion.
Okay. I do that.
Hey, baby.
I wasn't going to guess a skill, but I can guess a stat.
Okay.
Guys, let's put our names in character instead of our names.
Yeah, I changed that already.
Oh, right, I need to do that too. But I, you know, I say to her, like, I don't know, what do I say?
I got your side of the here. You're
going to be so good with the women, come on.
Yeah, I'm not, okay? Lily's not. Theo is. Theo is very good. I'm not, okay?
He is total ladies' man.
I'm married, and I haven't tried to hit on someone in a really long time, so I have no good moves anymore. They're all gone. But, I don't know, like, yeah. He's like, hey, I heard there were beautiful women in this tower. Looks like I was right. Also, I just happened to be down this road. Do you have any news? I'd love to chat. Something along those lines. That's what I've got. It's not very good. That's what I've got.
Smooth. Woo.
Thanks, bro.
Oh, you got a 15%.
I lean over to Aridin and say, he crashes and burns. One gold.
I've seen him in action.
Thanks, bro. All
right.
I've got some candy. Unicorn for Spooktember.
Nice.
Can you see my spooky baby ghost candle? It's so cute. I'll show you in a minute.
Do you want me to bring it to you, Lily, so you can show everyone?
Yeah. Just bring it to your camera.
We're gonna take a pause of D&D so that everyone can see the candle. It's very important.
It's very spooky.
It's spooktacular.
I'm pretty
actually.
Sure everyone has seen it, though, Lily, because it was
no,
at
ben
this
hasn't
apartment
seen
for
it.
Years.
And Brandon hasn't seen it.
He's come over.
Look
I also
how cute
can't
it
see
is.
You, though, because both of your cameras are frozen.
Yeah.
But those were here last year.
Yeah, Brandon doesn't observe.
I can't see any of you guys are.
Remember, we had a picture of him from his childhood on our wall and he didn't see it?
Yeah.
We talked about that.
I did see it. I didn't notice it.
I lost
2 days.
$5 that day.
Alright, so. You are trying to seduce the woman in the blue armor, and then you asked her.
Persuade her of my genuine interest in communicating with her further.
So
I would like to roll wingman.
So hold on. So she replies, "You know, it's good that you're here. You should come and you should come in. Hold on a moment." And she turns and as the drawbridge starts to come down. And she says, yes, you should come meet the commander. You're here just in time. Please, enter.
Can I, like, roll insight or, like, sense motive, some shit like that?
Sure, you could roll insight.
Because I want to know if she knows exactly who we are and heard from her other vulture-riding bros that they were attacked by people who fit our description and is setting us up.
Oh, yeah, did one make it away?
No.
Yeah, one got away.
Gotcha.
Didn't we kill?
No, one? You killed all three.
Okay.
That's oh, okay.
I just roll normal for insight, right?
I think.
Insight. Yeah, just hit
one
the
vulture got away, but
yeah, nothing that could speak.
She doesn't seem to recognize you guys in particular.
Cool. Great.
Like
fabulous.
That's all I need to know.
Shut up.
Great.
Stop storytelling, DM. Don't do your job.
Jacob, we can limit you to under three words per sentence.
You go in?
Yes.
A plus.
Yes.
She leads forward. Then go up.
I don't like this game.
Wait, what does the foyer look like?
Stone and wood.
No rich fabric draping.
I release you. You can speak. Release.
We have to go like this.
The entrance is a 30-foot-long hall of white stone. At the opposite end of the hall are two 12-foot-tall doors like those of the entry gate. An eagle carved from massive timber hangs from the far side of the ceiling, suspended on strong chains. Slender wings of steel sweep close to its sides. Its head is also fashioned of steel.
These people really like birds.
Yeah, I was just about to say, you certainly like your birds here. You have.
I like this place.
Well, we are flying. We are a group of flying mount enthusiasts, but please, the commander will tell you more. She leads you guys.
Wait! Can we ask if she's in a guild?
Just ask.
I do, but I'm saying, like, I want to ask her that. I don't know if Jake knows. Like, that's what I'm.
I know everything. I'm the GM. What I say is law.
Oh, are you in a mount enthusiast guild?
Guild is not quite the right word. We're more of an order. A society,
it's a
perhaps.
It's a fan club.
I can chill with that.
Oh, you beat me to it.
Was that in character, Salik?
You know what? It was snotty, so it should be.
I approve.
Just excuse me, and she's going to roll perception to see if she actually heard what you said.
Does she indeed perceive your snark? That's the question.
Sounds like she's hitting on you, Salik.
Not quite. She doesn't quite hear you. Excuse me.
I'm sorry, the dust. I'm not used to being down on the ground like this.
Anybody? No.
Are you insulting the house cleaning now? My God, you're a terrible guest.
Neither are we. We definitely prefer to be in the sky. Please. And she leads you guys. She opens these big doors and leads you guys to these spiral staircase that just goes up and up and up. Three floors up to the roof of this tower.
I'm dizzy.
To the tower. They're pretty wide spiral stairs.
Dizzy.
They're not like really tight, like spinning. You know, they're
dizzy anyway.
All right.
Severe motion sickness.
And
flying mounts aren't for you.
At the apex of the tower, the stairs terminate in a round stone gazebo that continues upward in a needle-like minaret. Beyond this enclosure, a small lawn grows upon the top of the tower. Four paths paved with white stones point the directions of the compass, each path ending in a pointed stone crenellation. At the pinnacle's edge is a spyglass on a tripod pointed downward. From this vantage point, this area possesses a supreme view of all that transpires in the nearby canyon and the Sumber Hills beyond.
Hey, Randy Major, what's a crenellation?
Yeah,
crenellations are the things on the side of the castle.
Of the castle. How it goes? Remember when you built the thing?
Oh, Jake, we were trying to find out that word like a couple weeks ago on Minecraft.
Oh, that's right.
It's also called a battlement if you want a different word, but that one's more general.
Yeah. Alex.
Yes.
So what you jump off in Assassin's Creed?
Yeah.
I understand.
You're speaking her language. All right. So she leads you up.
Unpredictable leap of faith.
And there's a man there. He's standing and looking out over the thing, and he turns around, and the commander of the Feathergale Knights is a well-built male human in his early 50s. Embossed feather patterns ornament the plates of his armor, and his kingly cloak boasts a feathered mantle. He smooths his white blonde hair into place, then bows low before you as if he were only a lowly courtier.
Lily's gone.
He's blind. I can't handle this anymore.
Welcome to the Feathergale Spire, retreat of the Feathergale Society. I'm Thurl Moroska, the Lord Commander.
Lord Commander.
Lord Commander.
Lord Commander, it is a pleasure to make your acquaintance. Can I hear your opinion on vultures, by any chance?
We indeed have some vultures here riding. The greater soldiers, the knights, ride griffins, but some of our lower initiates will ride giant vultures. Anyways,
very impressive. I like your cloak.
You've come here at a good time.
I do. It's cool.
Tonight, we're hosting a feast in honor of the Feathergale Society's 10th year.
Congratulations.
Well, that sounds like fun.
Yeah.
Yes, it is a great time to be here. We'd like to invite you to join us for dinner.
Can I ask what they do as a society?
Ah, yes, we...
have an old friend for dinner.
We are the Feathergale Society, an elite group of aerial mount enthusiasts, mostly from Waterdeep.
Oh, yes. Okay.
I look around to see if he's reading this off of a card.
Is this a country club?
It's basically a fucking country club.
Yeah, you get the feel. It's very much...
It doesn't matter.
It's very much like these people seem... They look like nobles who are here, like, in their off time for fun. Like, this is their, like... golf club, you know, like they go fly griffins to...
Okay, actually, though, my uncle is in a club where everybody owns small planes, and this is exactly how they behave.
It's very does angry. He have a cool feather cloak, though? No, he doesn't.
No, I don't think
not as good, Alex. It's not as good.
Well, even this vulture is made of metal.
Yeah.
Well, it's an honor to be here, and, Would we want to stay for dinner? Do we have...
We are honored starving. By this invitation from the aerial mount enthusiast. What a
the Feathergale Knights.
Day.
The Feathergale Society.
Dude, right. There's going to be free booze at this thing.
I immediately, like, grab at, like...
Dude, I bet that chick will be there.
Whatever twin is closer sleeve and just be like, we have likely dead dwarves to find. We can't just...
They're not going anywhere.
Yeah, they're dead.
Maybe these guys can.
They're literally disappearing as we speak. They may be rotting.
Is something wrong?
These guys.
No, what? Everything is fine. I appreciate your concern. No, thank you.
So will you be joining us for dinner?
Yes.
I say, yes, I'd love to. But there was something we came here hoping to ask you.
What is that?
We're looking for a dwarven delegation who's gone missing.
Ah, the Mirabarans.
Yes. We thought that you, with your mounts, might have seen them.
No, we have not seen them. However, and his face darkens. Great evil lurks among these hills. Depraved cultists led by wretched monsters. But let us speak of such matters after the feast has warmed our blood.
All right. We must stay for dinner, of course.
I mean, they did invite us. It would be rude not to.
Dude, I'm super down to hang with this guy. He is cool shit. I like him.
Really, I appreciate where you're all coming from, and I think a free meal would be lovely, but I just... You know, I don't like crowds.
Me and my brother are glaring at you, and we're like, what a fucking buzzkill. And I'm like,
so
you know
when
what,
will dinner be?
Yeah, Luna, you're right. You should scout ahead.
The feast should give you a
look back, like, really?
The feast should be ready in a few hours. In the meantime, you're welcome to rest here in the spire.
Sweet. Very gracious of you.
I'm going to go over and investigate that cool telescope.
Yeah.
I want to just get a good look at the valley.
Yeah, so...
That manticore lair.
So you're just going to, like, go up to it and look through it and then, like...
Hang on one second. I'm looking in there... Yeah, I would just like to get acquainted with this valley that we're in.
All right, so where are you going to, like, are you just going to look right in where it is, or are you going to point it out somewhere?
I'm going to look right where it is. I'm not going to move it first.
Okay, so, good call.
You see, it's pointed down into the canyon towards an area called Knife Point Gully, which I will show you again for a moment. Da-da-da. It's pointed down towards Knife Point Gully, and you actually see you see a hooded figure approaching the gully, and he reaches his hand up onto the wall, and there's a hidden door there, and he pulls it open and slides inside.
What?
Wait.
So what's he wearing? Is it just like a normal
a cloak with a hood? Yeah. Or... That's really all you saw.
It was
you just you like you caught the tail end of it as you peeked in.
I'll file that under weird.
And then as you like pan it around, you can see there's various wildlife in the thing. By the river, you see some there's a couple hyenas around by the river. You spy a couple griffins flying around. You can see there are cool. Some other Feathergale knights riding on griffins around.
Awesome.
A few out and about. In their
you
blue
slowly
armor,
grow more and more jealous.
Billowing white capes.
I'm glad they're having a good time.
Still billowing.
I can't do that anymore.
Ouch.
I don't know. He always has to bring you back there.
I do. It's kind of a big deal.
He has a feast in a couple hours. The feast will probably start at, like, I don't know, like 5 or 6, maybe 7, and so maybe it's like late afternoon, early afternoon.
Yeah, it's late afternoon. It'll probably be just a few hours.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, I don't know about this. I want to go do some prayers to my god. That's better. Go up to the very top, put some dragon bones down, pray to Sabras. Please let me see more in the future. I hope that is in my future. I don't know because you aren't telling
Lord,
me.
What's his face still here?
Lord Commander.
The Lord Commander, yeah.
Lord Commander, I say, where I'm from, my people don't build structures like this. I would love a tour.
Of course,
If that's the sort of thing you do here.
I'd be glad to show you around. And so he's happy to lead you guys down and around. So, at the very least, he's going to lead Salik. Is anyone else?
Yeah, I'll follow.
I'd like to go.
I'll follow up until he points out, like, quarters where he's like, hey, and this is where you guys can rest up, and I'll be like, and cool, and duck.
He goes right down. So here, I can bring up the map of the spire real quick. He's going to start by pointing out, like, there's a knight on his griffin, like, mounted at the edge of the pinnacle here on the roof, and he's going to point him out and just talk about, you know, our knights are some of the greatest, you know, aerial-mounted flyer pilot people around, et cetera, et cetera. I'm not good at talking.
I have no real metric for this, so I'm like, sure.
And then he's going to lead you guys down one floor, down the stairs, to level 3, and he's going to point out, you know, these are some of our officers' quarters for our, you know, for the head knights. We'll make one of them available for you guys to rest. And he snaps and like an initiate, like in a hood, like scurries over and he says, you know, make these quarters ready for our guests. And he scurries into the room to go deal with it.
I'd like to ask him a question.
Yeah.
What's with all the cloaks and the hoods? Don't they slow you down when you're flying? Are they parachutes?
But they look so cool.
Seem not very aerodynamic.
So this is the first person you've seen in a cloak or hood, and it's an initiate. They're like a...
No, we saw the lady in the billowing cloak out front.
Cape. A cape is very different from a cloak. A cloak wraps around you. A cape hangs behind you.
Okay. And still, he said the Lord Commander had a cape.
Yeah, cape, not a cloak.
Right.
A feathered cape, which is feathered super cool, cape. And I want to steal it. I won't, but it looks so amazing.
Saying some aerodynamic metal armor, maybe from a local blacksmith, might be better, make it faster. Look into it.
Yeah.
Just saying.
He says the armor of a Feathergale knight, in addition to being protection, confers a level of status.
We're all about status, so we feel that.
Yes, definitely.
I don't know if you've heard of us. We're the Eldris Brothers.
We do our bit again, where we think we're a really big deal. Eldris, we are locally famous.
I haven't heard of that noble family.
What is with these people out here?
It's because it's not a noble family.
I know.
We would not admit that.
True.
Yeah, I do my best to restrain that smirk.
So then he comes down another floor.
Level two?
Yeah, down to level two. I can bring this up again. You guys head out the doors here into this area. It's labeled S8.
That's where the feast is going to be, right?
And he says, yes, this is the Great Hall. And you see there's some more initiates scurrying around getting the feast ready. The Great Hall, you know, spans like the whole...
My first summer job was a waiter at the Feather Spire Keep. It was pretty good.
There's these between these large, like really large windows. There are tapestries depicting scenes of gallant knights on flying hippogriffs, fighting dragons, and jousting with one another among the clouds. High on the walls are the mounted heads of griffins, wyverns, owlbears, and manticores.
Wow.
Manticore.
Classy joint.
This is, yeah.
Maybe he also,
place has Michelin stars.
And he also is going to lead you guys around the back of the, just in a circle around there, and he says these are more quarters for the lower members of the society. And then he'll continue downward to the ground level, where he's going to show you guys to this room S7 here on the east side. And this is a solarium. The room is really bright. There's flowers and shrubs of a bunch of different varieties. Big windows and openings there. Spidery red and purple plants grow suspended in baskets in midair. Robed humans water the plants. A couple people in robes going around watering. And he's, this is the solarium. It's taken care of by the initiates, and it teaches them patience and
plant stuff
exactly. Let's see what else is gonna take you around. These other rooms down here in the hall include the kitchen, which you don't need to see right now. I'm sure they're very busy. The initiate dormitory,
is that S5?
I believe, yeah, S5 is the dormitory. Yeah, S6 is the kitchen. But here, let's continue down, and he takes you guys down to the stable level. So here, there's a circular landing surrounding the central shaft of the spiral staircase. The landing is piled with supplies and bales of straw. Radiating from the landing are 12 stalls with straw-covered floors. A harness, riding coop, and saddle hang in each stall. Swinging wooden doors cap either end of each stall, one leading from the tower to the stall, and the other leading from the stall into the open air. If you look around the stalls, there's a couple hippogriffs and two giant vultures. And there's a knight, again, blue armor, white cape, tending to them. He's like bringing around like a bucket, just taking care of the animals. He says, "These are our majestic beasts, our mounts. With them, we can sail across, fly across the skies," and da 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 da. And he's just going on and on about how great the mounts are. He starts talking about this.
I like how the vulture is like the trainer, and then there's the griffin, which you graduate to.
Oh yeah, totally. He starts talking about the pedigree of this particular griffin and how it's, for 9 generations it was of the right line of griffins, and they've been breeding them and all.
It's
this.
It's a water-deep short leg, which is the best for flying.
This is a cage-free pumpkin spice griffin. Delicious. The best guy.
So yeah, and he says, and this, that is our humble spire.
So,
I dig
do
it.
You guys ever eat poultry, or is that against the rules?
We're fine. Lesser birds, of course.
Right.
And in the case where we conquer a wild flying animal, of course we would like to feast upon its remains.
Me too.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Nothing like fresh sky kill.
Part of the hunt.
Shit, we should have gotten meat from those vultures. That was silly.
Vultures?
Or what were they?
Brandon, this next time.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, sorry.
If you said that in character, I was gonna cover for you. So just.
He turns and he says, yeah, "Vultures? You killed some vultures recently?"
Oh, small, tiny game. You know, feasting on carrion. It was disgusting.
Be careful.
I went up the sky with my bow. It was. I didn't want to bring it up. I wasn't sure if you'd be okay with it.
Careful eating those. They can sometimes carry disease.
Yeah.
Probably good we didn't then.
I told you not.
With that, with that, he leads you back up towards the quarters for you guys to rest. Back up to the third floor.
Awesome.
Can I steal bread from the kitchen on the way up?
You don't cut through the kitchen on the way there. It's a little out of the way. What was that, Alex?
I go out of the way to get bread.
I asked Ben if he was doing hand signals. I saw him doing this, and I was confused.
I think he was lamenting.
Being Pharaoh.
Got it. More like Pharaoh, am I right? Vultures.
I got it.
More like total ass clown, right?
Hey, I'm at least like 80% only ass clown. Just like 20% of not ass clown there, I'm pretty sure.
Ass clown runs in my family.
It's a condition.
Can't be all of them. Mentioned evil in the land. Cultists or some such, have they been causing problems recently, immediately in this area? We found some dead travelers on the road a while back, and we weren't sure what had happened.
And he says, please, in these dark times, we can talk more about this subject after the feast. I don't want to get in a dour mood.
Well, I'm ready for such a feast, but...
Wouldn't want to be a Debbie Dower.
A Dower.
Yep.
Deborah Dower.
She sounds pretty dour. Until the feast, then.
So I guess we just chill out till the feast then.
Cool.
Yeah, short rest.
Short rest, yep. You guys can recover some hit points from that last combat.
How do we do a thing with the points?
Ah, so on a short rest, you have hit dice. You have hit dice equal to your level. The kind of hit dice is determined by your class. You can choose to spend any amount of hit dice that you like. You roll those dice, you regain that many hit points. You don't regain the hit dice until you do a long rest. You regain half of your hit dice rounded down. So,
if I use one now when I sleep later, I'm Gucci.
Exactly. You'll gain one back.
Okay, but do I add like con or anything, or just roll it?
You add con.
Oh, you do? You click the button for hit die.
Yeah, you add your con.
Click a button. I clicked it.
Boom! Wait, you regained 10 hit points. Damn!
Alright, I can't gain 10. I only lost 5, but I have a million now.
Healed to full.
Well, I regained 9. You feel really good. 5, so, you know, that was really nice. I'm back to 14.
Good times.
Cool.
Do I want to roll another one? I'll roll another one.
Salik just goes to every object in this room that is not nailed down and is fiddling with it.
Okay, I can actually, I think...
What room are you in? Oh, you're in the room that they put us in, yeah.
Yeah, so this chamber...
If there are
any
small objects who catch his eye, he may keep them.
Yeah, so the chamber, there's two beds, a fireplace, a closet, two chests, and a small tapestry on the wall.
Is the fireplace lit?
Totally.
Okay, sweet. I'm gonna go to the kitchens right now.
You're gonna go downstairs to the kitchen?
Yep.
Alright.
I get... fresh bread and like a chunk of bacon or lard or pork or something.
The kitchen's really busy, and they're like,
I'm a strapping young lad, and I need my calories.
And they're like, these are for the feast. Hands off!
I like smack them away and grab the bread anyway.
Wow!
Oh my lord!
So weird.
One of them is like private profit.
I need a snack.
You're not you when you're hungry.
Private profit, I can't believe. And then you run off with your food before they get too angry.
Riff rat, street rat, I don't
Yeah, like while Theo's gone, Odin, where did your brother go?
Am I my brother's keeper?
Yes.
Are we voting? I vote for
probably
you.
Honestly stealing some bread or lard from the kitchen right now.
Aren't we eating in like a half?
I come back into the room and I'm like, dude, got some bread, check it out.
Told you.
I like stick it next to the fire and like get it warm again, and I'm like so excited.
Right,
simple
cool.
Things in life for him, isn't it?
Anything else you guys would like to do during your break before the feast?
I mean, no. I just rummage.
Cool.
Looking for shiny bubbles.
Are you going to open the chest?
Yeah. No, yeah. Does it open?
Yeah, there's two chests.
If they open, I open them.
Yeah, there are two chests. You open them. Each has a feathered cloak and various, you know, like, valuables, like some coins, some gems.
Get them with the cloaks.
Like various personal effects.
If there's like a gem that I think looks neat, I take it.
All right.
Wait, do I see you do this? Probably not. I'm probably busy stuffing my face. Let's be real. Never mind.
You find a gem worth?
I mean, he's not hiding at all.
You find a gem worth 2 gold pieces.
Ooh, cool. Man.
It looks rich really neat, here. Though. It's
like,
awesome.
Like, you think I'd be paying attention, but my passive perception is 9, and I am facing the fireplace, and I'm stuffing my face with a giant loaf of bread, so I probably honestly didn't see.
I would say Pharaoh and Reese definitely see this. Other people are busy with their own
things. Oh, was I hanging out around him?
I mean, you're in the same room, and you have a high passive perception.
Oh, gotcha.
You have a decent passive perception.
Yeah.
This is fine with Pharaoh.
I'm gonna bring that up. I'm gonna be like, why'd you just steal from these people? They're gonna feed us and, you know, give us rooming. Is this common amongst your people?
Oh, are you talking to me?
Yeah.
People. Why do you have to play the race card? Shit.
Throw down.
What's WWE suddenly?
What are you talking about?
I saw what you were doing.
What are you?
And?
I saw what you did.
I'm just asking. I'm curious.
Reese, Eric Cocker don't have things.
What do you mean?
I'm looking at the little gem. I'm like, looks neat.
They don't own things.
Oh.
What do you mean they don't own things? He has a what weapon do you use? Fish. Oh shit, you're a monk. Never mind. He has those clothes, doesn't he?
I have a quarter staff and a short sword.
There you go. What do you mean he doesn't own things? He has weapons.
Right.
I don't see him dropping them after the fight.
Could just kind of just say, "Hey, can I use this?" And he'd be like, "Sure." And they take it, and then they wouldn't even have to give it back.
No possessions.
No matter to me. Just don't talk about it quite so loud. They might get mad at you.
Am I speaking about it loudly?
Kinda.
You've
driven the GM to drink, so clearly this is getting a hand.
Pockets to the neat little gem. You landworkers are so weird about this whole object. They still don't get it.
Last time I checked, you were in our world.
This guy's a dick. I do not appreciate.
Not by design.
All the sass going on. I don't really understand the conversation, but I don't appreciate the sass.
Reese is telling him to go back to where he came from.
That's just rude.
We're gonna build a sky wall.
And it happened.
We're gonna build a sky wall and make them plane for it.
All right. Anything else before dinner?
Mm. No, I'm ready.
I think we're good.
Did I see that girl who let us in?
Yeah, you probably saw her on your way to the kitchen and back. She's down in the main hall.
Okay, I like, you know, eyebrow at her.
Why don't you give me a charisma roll, just straight charisma.
Okay, but just to clarify, I'm eyebrowing at her and then acting like I don't care.
Advantage on your charisma roll.
Great, that's what I was going for.
Very Dow of Steve of you.
Wait, is it? It's charisma? It's just charisma?
Just plain charisma.
Okay.
Yeah.
With advantage. All right. She, like, as you said, she says, like, you could tell that, like, she's trying to look like she's focusing on her work, but she's definitely watching you leave, like.
Dope. I have a great butt.
How old is this lady?
I don't know, like, late 30s.
Okay. I was thinking of, like, an older person.
No, she's not, like, old, but.
Okay. What are you talking about? Why would she be old? Young.
She's not old, but Theo likes a woman.
Right. I'm how old are we, brother?
You said 21 last time when 21. You
got. Okay, yeah, cool. That's how old we are.
It's fine.
How long fine. Until it's a cougar? What's the official cutoff?
Once the leopard prince pants start.
She's wearing leopard print pants. Doesn't matter how old she is.
All right, so
I've seen 12-year-olds.
After a couple hours, an initiate comes up and says, "The feast is ready."
Wow. Your dad must be rich.
I thank him and I head over to the hall.
He keeps, like, standing there, so you guys walk past and down to the hall. Just sort of, like, swaying.
I can't.
I head down the hall excitedly. I'm like, oh, the feast.
You get down there and
starving for days.
Oh, me too. I'm so famished.
I lean over to Theo and say, "That kid looked unfortunate. I can't tell half of you apart, and I know he looks like he fell down the enemy tree."
You call me racist.
Clad in no one. Clad in the finest garments of velvet brocade, the knights feast at a carved table in the great hall, where twin hearths blaze. Thurl Moroska, the commander, sits at the head of the table. As you guys all sit down, he stands up and holds up a goblet and says, "Honored guests, tell us of your adventures in the Sumber Hills. Let us aid you in any way you can. Any way we can."
Oh, we should talk, because we were sent by the mayor and we think it's really cool. Sorry, that was Lily.
totally in character.
Oh, also, sorry, this is important. Is his hair, like, slicked back?
No, it's parted.
I still judge him a little bit, but his cloak is so amazing that it's just, it's fine.
Kind of like this.
It doesn't really matter. Yeah, that looks terrible. No, I'm just kidding.
Well, thanks, wife.
No, it's okay. Okay, brother, talk.
What do you want me to say? What's your idea?
Look how awesome we are.
I already did that earlier.
Okay, it's starting to get a little awkward as he's standing up there with the goblet.
Salik stands up and he says, We have been tasked with locating the dwarven delegation, but sadly the trail has run cold. We came to you hoping you could help us."
The mayor personally selected my brother and I to accompany them. We're from Redlarch. You may have heard of us.
Don't worry, we're not just a bunch of nobodies.
Yeah.
We're the Elders brothers.
Yeah.
You see a bunch of people looking around like, "Do you know this guy? Not Eldris? Like, are we behind on the news? Like,
I hope this turns into everyone pretending to know they know who you are."
Someone goes, "Yes, the Eldris brothers, of course."
Yeah. So yeah.
I'm like, "We encountered Earth cultists at Thumber Hills. Signs of a bull and fallen." What's the delegation called?
Mirabarin. They're from Mirabar.
Mirabarin. And signs of a fallen Mirabarin delegation caravan guards.
We then valiantly rode off to try to find the culprits. Alas, we could not, only finding this tower, which we believed may have been their lair.
Shut the fuck up, Pharaoh.
It starts to get a little awkward in there when all of a sudden the doors to the Great Hall fly open, and a sentry from the pinnacle shouts, "Manticore, it's on the move!"
Of course.
Okay. At this announcement, the Feathergale Knights rise as one, the feast before them unfinished. The commander stands up and says, "We should take this opportunity to slay the monster. From his finger, he removes a feather-patterned gold ring set with a garnet and holds it aloft, saying, "A prize for the one who brings me the beast's head."
Oh, dude, I want that shit so bad.
It's just feather.
Shiny.
It's just feather.
He turns and he says,
the principle of the thing, Luna.
Honored guests, I invite you. Please join my knights in the manticore hunt. I will lend you 4 or 6 of our finest hippogriffs so that you can ride with them.
Is Jake's video frozen for anyone else?
No, yeah. Frozen for me too.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. It's not frozen on stream.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. My video will never be frozen on stream because I'm the one streaming, so it's
cool.
Good.
As long as you can hear me. I whisper kind of loudly, "Does anyone here know how to ride a hippogriff? And also, what's a hippogriff?"
I'm just super confident, and I'm like, "It would be an honor," and I'm like so totally jazzed, and I like get up from the feast and like quaff my whole jug or whatever, and like I'm totally down. Super down.
Ooh. I'm down to kill a trophy.
Antithesis of down. Just like doesn't say anything, but you just look at Luna's face and she looks like someone just like poured a bucket of water on her. It's just like
Aridin and I
we accept this noble quest. Except and then, for and that one over there. She doesn't.
Yeah.
No, I'll go.
Okay, yes. We accept this noble quest, including her.
And she does too.
And now and we
shall fall.
And he says to the pinnacle, and he leads you guys up to the top.
Cool.
When you get there, 4 Feathergale knights assemble at the pinnacle, each mounted upon a giant vulture. The moon illuminates the misty canyon below Feathergale Spire. In the far distance, a single shard of darkness moves, flitting in and out of the mist. Then the shadow sinks beneath the bank of clouds, lost again from sight. Along the edge of the pinnacle, there are also 6 hippogriffs, each there with an initiate, like, holding them, like, you know, by their reins, sort of, like, you can tell some of the initiates, like, are pretty skinny and small, and they're sort of getting flung about between the wind and the hippogriff, but
so
they're there.
So this hippogriff attack seems a little bit more
planned.
All right.
Here comes
Yeah.
Here comes some handle animal checks.
Oh, I have negative 1 go up to one animal of them, handling.
Because I really want to fly.
Yeah, so you're going to...
Can I fly on yours with you, or are they not that big?
But this is totally foreign to me. The whole idea that you would ride something else that flies, I don't get that.
Thurl comes right up behind you as you go, and he gives you a hand so you can step into the reins and up onto the hippogriff.
I weigh nothing, by the way.
Yeah,
yeah.
So,
I'm like 90 pounds soaking wet.
Yeah.
Is it possible to ride with him? Because I don't want to try to handle one of these things on my own. I don't think I can.
Okay, so you're going to ride with Sleek?
I was about to ask.
What do you mean you can't handle one of the things on your own? You have the best wisdom here.
You don't know my wisdom.
I was going to say, from what he's shown you, he's the least wise.
Yes.
Accurate.
No, he's stupid.
There's a difference. My wisdom is not an embodiment of my actual wisdom. It's an embodiment of the fact that I'm pretty lucky and the little dragon bones actually most of the time do tell me the right path. It's not my personal wisdom.
So I'm sitting in this hippogriff. I guess I like, spur it?
Yeah.
Like, go.
And he goes, you know, makes a big old noise, and then leaps off the front of the tower and dives down and starts getting picks up a lot of speed, and then, you know, turns up and is going really fast and heading out towards the manticore.
Dope. Okay.
Greatest.
That looks so cool. Can we do that?
Yeah. Theo and Aridin, I assume, are each going to ride their own.
Yeah, we're way too buff to share.
Luna, are you going to try and ride one of them, or?
I look at both of them, blink a couple times, then turn to Reese. Would it be possible to ride with one of... and then I just, like, immediately turn away and just turn to Reese. Reese, can I come with you?
Sounds fine. I get dibs on the ring if we kill it, though.
Sure. Happy to let... Look, I'm just not good with my hands, all right?
So, all right, so we got 4 hippogriffs going, and then there are 4 of the knights on giant vultures. Cool. So the you guys all get on your thing. Same thing, that you know, your hippogriffs jump off, and Theo and Aridin, Thurl says, you two brothers might want to ride this pair of hippogriffs. They are brothers themselves.
Dude, twins on twins!
And so he puts you guys on this pair of brother hippogriffs. And these brother hippogriffs, they leap off and dive down, like, symmetrically, like, spin and cross each other and then come up. Like, it's really cool.
That's so cute.
And you can tell that the brothers themselves are like, racing a little bit, the hippogriffs.
That's cute.
As you fly on them. And Reese and Luna, your guys' hippogriff, you know, jumps off, does the thing, and just sort of just goes straight off the thing at regular speed.
Good. I'm very comfortable riding this.
It can feel that both of its riders are, like, barely holding on, like, and not leading very strongly.
And they're noobs.
Yo, hey.
Hey, what's up?
Are hippogriffs the ones that can fly upside down?
Totally, yeah.
I try to fly upside down.
I follow Aridin's lead.
Aridin, give me a dexterity saving throw. Theo, also give me a dexterity saving throw if you're going to do that too.
The ultimate save.
Please. Die.
Please. Aridin, you're fine. Theoden, you're fine as well. you guys are like, your feet are in stirrups, you're holding a saddle, as long as you're gripping with your knees, you know, like when it starts to turn, you're fine.
Okay, but we get right back up again, and I'm like, let's not do that again. I feel not good. It was not
as cool. Let's tell everyone how awesome it was.
No.
All right. You can only see about 100 feet because it's dark and there's fog around. But the hippogriffs clearly know the canyon very well. And even though you guys start flying low and around some of these, like, things that are sticking up, just kind of like the spires on a thing that's sticking up out of the canyon, they are very deftly maneuvering and avoiding those. They clearly know it very well.
I am terrified.
I'm impressed and feel like we should invest in getting some hippogriffs.
So how are you guys going to group up? So there's the four knights, and then you guys have four things. Are you gonna go separate from the knights and try and do them together? Are you guys going to split up yourselves? How do you guys want to do this?
Are the knights moving as, like, a four-unit squadron, kind of? Like, all in a pack?
Yeah, I believe so.
If they're taking it head-on, I think we should flank.
What are these knights holding, like, armor? Or not armor, weapon-wise?
Probably a lance.
Lances? Yeah, I can tell you. They have...
Or swords. Or spears.
They have sword. Yeah, they have swords on their belt and they have spears on their back.
Okay.
Are pretty sturdy. They're lance-like, but they're spears.
Right. I'll hang out around the knights just because I'm going to use my bow, not my actual.
We could also do Mighty Duck formation.
Which is?
I don't know it.
Yeah. You guys haven't seen the Mighty Ducks?
Not since I was like 8.
Yeah. So you guys gonna go with those knights or on your own?
Ducks fly together.
I'm going with.
I think we should flank, but that's just me.
You guys can split up among yourselves too. Like, this is totally fine.
Aridin, are you cool with flanking?
Yeah, sounds good.
Come in from the side when they're not expecting us and steal the kill.
If I got a good look at this valley through that telescope, I should be able to make my way around.
Yeah, and also the hippogriff clearly knows knows the area really well.
So I'm not worried about getting lost.
Nope. You Gucci.
Yeah, I say if we're trying to find this thing, we should kind of split up.
We're not trying to find it, are we?
It's not clear where it is. Like, you could see it for a little bit, and then it dove into the clouds, and you can really only see 100 feet. There's lots of fog and clouds around. Like,
I thought we were going to lair.
You know vaguely where it is, because it's come out of its lair. You don't want to fight a manticore in its lair.
Right.
There's no hunt in that. Also, it's hard. the manticore is flying about, you know, it's going out to get its own dinner, presumably, and now is when you want to strike, you want to find it, so.
Okay.
We left the feast to be a feast.
Right. Wait, what?
More like to kill the beast.
Freakishly prophetic. Thanks, Luna.
So I say we stick together.
Okay.
Why don't we just go in full formation with these knights? Why?
Because the manticore won't attack that.
What makes you think that the manticore won't attack us?
I think that's the point. We want. Yeah.
Yeah, he wants to be attacked.
You know, the creature out thing. I volunteer Salik, of course, but I mean, he's got a cleric on his back. He'll be fine.
Pocket heals.
I don't see a need to change my plan, though. Like, I think we'll just flank them so we can look a little bit in a different direction from the main pack, but I'm going to try to keep the knights in our peripheral vision so we don't get totally separated.
Yeah, Jake, we'll move 100 feet off of them.
Yeah, exactly. Jake, did you follow that?
So you guys are going to stay, like, sort of separate 100 feet away from them, but
we're flanking so that we can look in a slightly wider area, but we want to keep them at a peripheral vision.
I don't know what you mean by flanking.
Okay, so like,
are,
if they're moving like this, I'm traveling
feet abreast of them.
That
yeah, they're moving
sense.
Parallel.
Cool.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Works.
All right. Cool. So
maybe slightly less than 100 feet, because he said we could only see 100 feet.
I'd like someone to roll a d20, adding one for each character and knight in the group.
Wait, what?
D20 plus 8.
Okay. Cool. Thanks.
I'd like someone to say. I don't want everyone to roll.
Oh, I'll roll it. I'll roll
too
it.
Too late.
Oh, man. Come on, Luna.
Call in when I ask, just so that we don't all roll it.
I didn't understand.
All right, so you guys search for a minute or so, and you don't find anything. You hear some noises occasionally, and you head that way, but then, you're not quite finding it.
Can I yell to Pharaoh?
Just do it.
Pharaoh.
You can.
Talk to your god lady person. Find us that little thing so I can go back to drinking.
Oh, I'm talking to her, all right.
He's holding on to Salik.
There's like little wing nubs, like awkwardly, like rubbing against your chest. You're too close.
Yeah, it hurts. It's not comfortable.
I think in this case, eyes might be best for looking. There's too many directions to ask, and I don't have that kind of power. And to be honest, I don't want to roll my bones right now. If I'm gonna lose my own bones, then I would like to keep at least the dragon ones. Those ones are nice. Please don't drop me, please don't drop me, please.
Oh my gosh. People roll my eyes. I'm like, well, that's out. Okay. What attracts a manticore?
Food.
Meat.
We should let it come to the feast.
Are you guys going to continue searching as a group of 8?
I think we should keep doing that. More eyes are better.
Yeah.
All right, somebody give me another roll.
Everybody looking at the same. Not so much different.
Ben, hit it.
Roll it again?
Yep.
Yeah, but don't do it bad this time. Roll good this time.
Okay. At one incoming. 27.
There you go. All right.
I say.
So right as you guys are saying, like, well, I don't know, like maybe it went back to the lair, but then, boom, there it is. It rises out of the clouds right as you guys are coming towards it. There's the manticore. What are you guys gonna do?
Nice.
And what are the knights doing?
Shoot it with my arrows.
All right. Cool. In that case, let's roll initiative.
Are you going to roll initiative for the knights, too? Are they going to, like, act as a group?
They will act as a group, indeed.
Okay, cool.
Knight, manticore, hippogriff, and all y'all.
Oh, I rolled real bad on initiative.
Initiativo. Well, we're framed by the brothers.
Initiative Dish Network.
Ha ha ha.
Cool, cool, cool. All right.
You like a turn tracker?
Paper.
He has it on his own.
Yeah, since we're on stream, I'm not using that one.
Oh.
Sorry. Oh. All right. Luna, are you the 7 that's hiding up there, or is that are you further up?
I am 7.
All right.
So and then Reese is even higher up with a 14.
Reese is up there. Okay, that's the... Okay. Got it. Oh, I can look at this screen. All right. Pharaoh, that's a 3. Theo, that's a 2.
Which is perfect, ooh, because I'm closing my eyes. I don't see it.
Sleek, 18. Eridan, 19. The knights are going to operate together. They have that. Boom,
they came
okay.
From...
Behind! And the manticore...
Just one more pass!
One more pass around!
Detach tow cable!
All right. So the knights have a 17. The manticore has an 11. So we're going to start with Salik.
Shouldn't we start with Aridin?
Sorry, Aridin.
Yeah.
My bad. Sorry.
I would like to shoot him with my crossbow.
All right.
Bang.
Do you have a light crossbow?
Yeah.
Okay.
Bam!
The strong thighs doesn't need a light crossbow.
That is for sure going to hit. That is most definitely going to hit.
And!
And do 3 whole damage. Oh.
Hell yeah!
At least you hit it.
I just didn't have my strength behind it. You know, if I could throw the arrows,
it'd be better. Totally.
Did you roll a 1 on your damage roll?
Yeah, I think so. Oh, no, that would be red, right?
Yeah.
Not for damage, I don't
think. Not for damage, no.
It's dexterity, so.
You can hover over it to see. All right. Anything else, Aridin?
Nah, I'm good.
All right, cool.
First attack. I got its attention.
All right, now it's Salik's turn.
I'm gonna yell, hey, stupid thing. Are you a bird or not? Decide.
Sweet insult. Love it.
Bolting it.
Bird. It's gonna go and dart.
Yeah, that hits.
For 8 piercing damage.
Nice.
Sweet accuracy.
Very.
Awesome.
Go for the eyes.
Cool. After Salik is the knights. So the knights, very clearly, very practiced. 2 of them off to the left, 2 of them off to the right. Spinning, coming around the opposite sides, flanking. And they're going to start, they come around either sides of it and each start throwing their spears at it. One of those crits. Looks like 3 out of 4 of those hit. One of them crits, so that is a total of...
Many damage.
5, 10, 15, 20 damage altogether.
Wow.
Nice.
Very clearly, very coordinated. You see they go right for, their spots land, like a manticore's covered in, these spikes and spines and stuff. I have a really shitty picture here, because it's a photocopy of my monster manual. Take a look right there. There's very clearly some parts. You didn't see it?
Well, no, you're still frozen on my
still
screen.
Still frozen. I'm sorry.
It's fine.
They very clearly have really good aim and are going right for the weak spots towards the belly and under the arm and the leg. Like they very clearly know what they're doing and want to take this thing down. They're also you can hear them shouting at each other You know, you're not gonna fell it. I'm gonna fell. I'm gonna get that ring. Even though they're still very coordinated, they're still
excellent shot, Reginald.
Yeah, they're totally. Just shit talking each other, really sarcastic.
Oh, quiet.
High class shit talk.
We're gonna blow these guys out of the water.
We're gonna bro them out of the water.
We're gonna bro them out of the water. They're not gonna know what hit them.
If anyone would.
Yeah. All right, Reese, you're next.
You don't understand how good we are.
I'm going to shoot my arrow at it with my bow. Short bow. Pew. Normal roll. Nope. Certainly not.
That nat one.
I know. Great to start off the game Twang. With this.
Hey, it gets it out of the way. Now exactly. You can't roll another one. That's how it works.
So that misses.
Yes.
And in fact... you hit one of the knights.
Oh, okay.
Okay, cool. It's on me. It doesn't matter.
Because you're shooting across and they dove forward. So go ahead and roll me some damage on that.
Max damage.
It's not a bad damage roll, actually. It's a okay. 1. You roll a 1.
And they go, watch your fire!
Wait, can I cover for him?
Sure.
I mean,
oh my gosh, that manticore is shooting arrows. This is horrible. This is crazy.
You're firing arrows.
Roll bluff with disadvantage.
I saw it too.
Oh my god.
Bro. Wait, can I get regular now? Because I have a corroborator.
No.
Wait, deception is the thing?
Yeah? Yeah, deception with disadvantage.
Oh my god, it's firing arrows. It's scarier than we thought.
Yeah, no.
The magic is not shooting arrows.
But
haven't you known don't insult you don't have a good me, he shouts.
I'm hoping that joking. When you get back, you're gonna make fun of Reese and the guy who got hit by Reese.
All right, yes. Then it's the Manticore's turn.
No, it shoots arrows.
It won't attack us. We're helping.
No, it shoots tail spikes.
What? That's see? Even worse. No.
Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. Manticore shoot tail spikes.
Yeah. Yeah. No, it's fine. See, they shoot arrows.
We're helping.
All right.
For all it knows, we're helping. It won't hurt us.
Yeah, thinks we're on the same team, right?
Right.
It trusts us.
Who's attacked it so far? Aridin and Salik?
Me.
Yeah. Cool.
And
so
and the knights.
And the knights, right. So Aridin, that an 18 is going to hit you because you don't have your shield out because you're flying.
No.
So that is 7 damage, 7 piercing damage. Salik... 19 definitely hits you, so that's same to you, 7 piercing damage.
I catch it.
God damn it! alright, you catch it.
I hand it to Pharaoh.
So do you not even have to spend key to do that?
No, I'm going
to
use a key point. I'm going to use a key point to throw it back.
So no, you could just deflect missiles whenever you want. Oh, it uses up your reaction.
It uses his reaction.
I can do...
So if something attacks
it
multiple times,
my reaction,
times,
but I'm going
once.
To...
Got it.
Exactly.
I'm going to go ahead and spend a key point to throw that back.
Let's see.
And
if you hit.
There's a magic item that gives that ability to anyone.
That's cool.
Without the key point.
Oh, dang.
So. Yeah, you're going to miss.
No, it just is a one per day.
Oh, no.
But still, it looked awesome.
You're like...
Really?
And,
character, you should have given it to Pharaoh and be like, analyze this back at the lab to cure us later when we find out these are poison.
all right. After the Manticore is Luna.
Okay. Let's see. I can't use any of my actual spells without horribly murdering everything around us.
Please don't.
We don't know. Do your thing.
Please don't.
Let me just
go with the old classic.
No, I have a alternate idea.
Sounds dangerous.
It is very dangerous.
Oh, it's completely dangerous. It's bad for us, but it's worse for it.
So this thing's AC is between 18 and 13.
As I was gonna say, as most ACs are.
Yeah. Screw it. So I'll just take the fun approach.
It's not a Tarrasque.
Yeah.
You're made of living flesh.
I'll just raise up the little small piece of like brass that I carry with me, and just you see a little bit of dark energy focuses, and I just Eldritch Blast towards it.
Yeah, classic.
And let's see how it goes. 9!
Not quite gonna hit.
You're doing
this whole moving target, moving horse thing.
Yeah.
The
Sky
math
ponies,
gets hard.
You know.
Yeah, that's going
to
miss.
See,
all right.
Reese, I at least know how to miss my allies.
Who says I wasn't aiming for them?
Pharaoh?
Pharaoh looks, trying to sum up the
screams.
Courage, like opens an eye and does a hand movement, and he says, "Sovereign, guide my allies so that we may fail this beast quickly, so that I may light upon the ground quickly and safely, please." Tries to cast guiding.
Oh God, save me!
God.
Keep in mind, guys, as far as spells, this is the same day as the other attack.
Yeah, no, I only have 2 left.
Cool, just checking.
18.
That'll hit.
Yes! Guiding Bolt! 9. See, there's the worst rules. You can do 9 instead of 26 sometimes.
Yep, alright.
However, everybody until next turn takes advantage on their attacks.
Everybody
fine,
or just the next
warlock.
Attack?
Next attack.
Is it
next I think it's just the next attack. Otherwise,
yeah,
it would be broken.
Yeah.
instead of
otherwise
just
it would be better than the level one spell. Yeah.
I'm a warlock, so I have all my spells back. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
On a short rest.
I'm a monk. I get all my key points back on a short rest.
Yep. Warlocks got everything on short rest.
Damn. All right.
Why?
So do monks.
Because we only have 5 slots total.
I only have six.
No, but I only have 2 right now. We only get 5 slots max.
Got it. Oh, I got it. Okay, cool.
Theo, it is your turn.
Cool. Okay, I want to scooch my griffin up like right next to its face and then warhammer it in the face.
Well, you can do like a flyby warhammer.
Like a flyby warhammer to the face kind of scenario.
Cool.
So we've got a, you know, 1,000-pound griffin. How much does a griffin? How much does a hippogriff weigh?
Probably like it's not like a horse.
Yeah, it's like a horse. It's a large.
It's fucking huge. Right.
It's a large.
Right. 900 pounds. Warhammer person following. I'm assuming like 40 miles an hour.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, why not?
This is gonna hurt.
It's gonna be awesome. Is what it's gonna be, and I get advantage, right?
No.
Guiding bolt.
Oh yes, guiding bolt.
Okay, cool. This but I have awesome. To do it one-handed because.
Because you're riding a.
I'm holding.
Thing. You gotta yeah one handed.
I'm still driving the whip. Body. Doesn't happen on a griffin. Yes. Okay, so I will roll that.
Okay. 21.
That hits
nice.
Right.
Yes, indeed.
Cool. Wait, and then I click the thing.
Yep. Yes. Click Warhammer one hand. There you go.
Nice.
11 damage. Nice.
Yeah.
However, as you fly away from it, right, as you pass it doing this, it's going to take a swipe with its claw.
Wait, Alex, do we have a thing to prevent that?
It's
an opportunity attack.
Can I use this when it's not my turn, Lily? Can I use our maneuvers?
No, that's... Unless it says as a reaction.
It'll
there
say
are reaction one.
It'll
oh,
say
no, I can't. It's
as
when
an
I,
action,
it's when I hit,
as a reaction,
no,
as a bonus
sorry.
Action.
Nope.
Yeah.
I have to plan that.
Gonna swipe at you and miss.
Oh, okay. Cool. It sucks. I hate
yeah,
it.
It swings at you, but you do that upside down spin thing again. You hit it and twirl away because since you've practiced it once, you can do it this time and you
don't
twirl
like
away
it.
And it misses you.
Yeah. Well, it sucks. So. Okay.
Catches some hippogriff claw in defense.
Good.
Cool. And back around to the top, Aridin.
Yes.
That's why your initiatives are where they are, so the brothers can act together.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I would like to try to skewer with my sword.
Alright.
Do it, bro.
I'm gonna fly in. And
no, use your thing. Use your thing.
What thing?
Your actions. Do you have action surge? No, wait. Yeah. Do that.
Yeah. Okay.
Just try to hit it again.
Jake, that misses, right?
What? Sorry? 11 misses, yeah.
Yeah, alright. I will action surge.
Alright.
Do hit it again. Ah!
Wow.
A 2.
8 really
I
misses.
Shall smite it.
So, basically, you were also trying to do a flyby?
Mm-hmm. I was trying to be cool, like my bro.
Cool.
It's not falling for that twice.
Do you have the great weapon fighting thing? Or did you take a different thing?
I have dueling.
That's right. Okay, cool. Never mind.
Cool. Alright. Then we have Salik.
All right, I'm about to do something really stupid.
Oh, God, I know what you're going to do already.
I say, Pharaoh, hold on. And I pass him reins.
Oh,
God. I'd like to jump off of my hippogriff and try to land on the manticore.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
You can tell by his reaction.
I would like an acrobatics roll.
just tell him to do it, why don't you?
You ready to start killing some characters, boys?
No, he's fine. He's a monk. And
he has permanent feather fall.
Oh, he does.
And
he
that one.
But it falls only if you're near a thing for monks, I think. You have to, like,
yeah, no, he has to be near a surface.
Oh, no, one. As an Aarakocra, he has permanent featherfall.
Okay, yeah. The monks get something else.
Yeah, the monk thing is different, but yes. Yeah. You miss completely.
Oops. It's over there.
Also, my eyes are
so is that like my action? Or is that my move action? Because I have a backup plan.
You're now falling. That was your move. You still have a regular action.
Then I'm gonna fist of unbroken air him and see if this works.
Disadvantage because you are falling.
Oh, it's not a. It's
the spell.
Yeah. It's hard to cast a spell while falling through the air. Oh, it's a save. Darn. Then he's going to have advantage on his save is how we'll do that. It's a dexterity... Oh, no, strength save.
He doesn't need advantage on a DC 13 unless he double nat one.
I know, right? That's just mean.
Yeah, he passes it. He passed it on the first roll, so even if I didn't give it to him, he would have passed.
Rude manticore, I hate these bitches.
See, you like, oh shit!
When
you do your little thing, and it just, you're falling, and it just goes way off the side of him, totally misses.
Whatever.
He takes
See you guys later.
you're falling, but slowly, because of your wing.
I'm still convinced that you're... I'm convinced that you chickened out. I'm like, wow. Must have been doing really bad. Embarrassed much.
The knight says, can't even stay on his mount.
I do hit it, though. It takes 9 damage.
One of the knights is gonna... He's got a pretty bad wound from the manticore spike. And he says, I'll meet you back at the spire, brothers! And he heads off. But the other three are gonna each throw spears again. The manticore is not looking good. Just so you guys know, it's bleeding pretty badly.
Did you account for my 9 damage?
What 9
damage?
Just want
to make sure you heard that.
He did 9 damage.
It's half damage.
Oh, it's for
on
half?
A failed save.
All right.
Yeah.
That manticore
and it doesn't get
pushed
or anything.
Yeah, this means that most definitely the knights are going to win.
No, but I want to get it.
And are they all totally unconcerned that I fell off, that I jumped off my thing?
They're laughing at you.
Yeah, one of them said, ha, he can't even stay on his mount. They can see that you're not falling that fast.
Yeah.
You're like a bird-looking dude. You're probably fine.
Yeah, they're like, they assume I'm fine.
Yeah.
The guy that turned around is a little chicken shit. I got speared too, and I'm fine.
That's how I feel.
One miss, one hit. Another miss. Only one's gonna hit for...
And he does negative damage, and we get the killing blow.
It's not quite going to finish off the manticore.
Yeah.
You guys lucked out. If another one of those would have hit, that would have finished it. The manticore's really weak. Like, one of its wings is like, the spear got it in the wing, and it's like, yeah, it's starting to lose altitude a little bit.
I'm glad we both imitated the dying manticore.
Okay. All right.
How much damage did the knights do?
Only 5. Only one spear made it. Out of 3. With that, we're gonna go on to Reese.
Reese.
Okay, we'll see how poorly my rolls are. short bow once again.
Wait, can I ask Reese, not to be a shitty person, question, how is he firing a short bow while also taking the reins?
You can momentarily let go of the reins and shoot a bow. It's like shooting a mortar.
With
your knees.
You have to have quads of steel, though. I think he's
not trying to be nasty.
It's just difficult. As long as you're not like maneuvering, since Theo and Aridin were maneuvering, right? They're doing a flyby. They needed a hand on the reins to steer.
Rolling.
Since he's far away and he's going at a steady pace, he can grip with his knees. Get a thing ready and go for it.
That's a hit, right?
25. That is a hit for sure. Roll me some damage.
Way to Hawkeye this.
Add a 1 on his damage roll.
That is enough damage. That you're gonna hit it, and the Manticore's gonna shriek out in pain.
No,
as,
I wanted
as
to kill it.
Its other wing seizes up, and it just starts going straight for the ground.
So I'm just going to be on the ground, and just this dead manticore is just going to wham.
The manticore actually falls past you.
Yeah, the manticore falls in an empty glade, and Salik is there to hear it. What sound does it make?
Wha-bam!
A gross, gross crunching noise.
Yep.
All right.
A sloshing.
So the knights say,
"Bow and victory."
Ah, good hunt, sir. Good hunt, sir. You,
actually,
you are the victor.
Good show,
everyone. Good show.
So for real, if it got to my turn, I was gonna jump off and then use the arms of Hadar as I pass by.
All right. So, also, Salik, your griffin flies around and catches you because you're falling slow enough that it turns around to come and catch you and goes, "Oh, like wow, that was easy," and it and it scoops up under you and catches you. And you guys, and the knights start heading down, and I assume you guys follow to go down and cut off the head of the manticore to mount it on the wall and show that you killed it.
What do they have to cut the head off with?
They've got big old long swords. Yeah.
Yeah, but I have a great sword.
Yeah,
so you could be like, step aside.
I want to do that. I mean, really.
Me.
You shouldn't bring a longsword to a greatsword fight.
It's just, please, I've heard of the grandeur of the Eldris family.
I too.
Hack it off.
I go to that guy and I say, "You know, they love to hear the stories you've heard about them. That really gets you on their good side."
Okay, I'll be sure to tell them all the stories I know. So Theo, you're gonna hack it off there.
Yeah.
Cool. I'm not gonna make you roll for that. You get your big old greatsword out and it takes a couple hits.
I've got like
a couple strikes.
19 strength. That not a big deal.
Take a strike or two, not a big deal. You're able to get this out of it. It's just that it's big is why it takes like two or three hits. If it was
Which
a normal,
is why I brought the greatsword.
If it was a short, if it was like a, you know, a human head, you could have done it in one. But
yeah,
big mana cores are big. All right, excellent job, guys.
I hate to have the rest of this manticore go to waste. It's a very cool belt.
Pardon? You cut out there for a second.
Oh,
I was just gonna say, I think we should field dress this thing. Because it's a cool pelt here. It's probably delicious.
Oh, and one of the knights says, "Oh, we'll just send the initiates out after it. There's no need for us to dirty ourselves."
Wow. I think these guys are hilarious.
Can I pull the manticore spike out of my body?
Yeah.
Please. I feel like this hurts.
Yeah, I recommend that, in fact.
Just a little bit.
I'm good!
You're doing a... Go ahead,
you can
Lily.
Second wind if you want to.
I was going to say, are you going to second wind as you do that?
No, I just don't want it in me anymore.
Okay. all right. So they load the head up. One of them takes out a net thing that he has and attaches it to the back of Reese, of your hippogriff, with the head in tow, so you can fly with it hanging off the back there. And everyone
Reese
remounts.
Did want the ring.
Yes, I did.
Everyone remounts, and they said, "To the spire!" And they take off.
Where it landed, it's nowhere near the dude. Nowhere near Point Gully, right?
English?
You
We're
are
down by, like, the manticore layer?
You are, to show you where you guys are.
That'd be helpful.
You are actually somewhere near the Howling Plateau.
Oh, so we're like right there.
Yeah, you're decently close to Knife Point Gully. So everyone is very clear. Like, the knights are like, "Let's head back to the spire, you know. Victory, let's drink."
Keeping that in mind.
Yeah, for sure. I feel you. Aw, damn it, you guys. I forgot something very important. I had an excellent surprise for the manticore fight. I was going to click this button right here, and... Wait for it. There it is.
Music.
Some music. It was going to be epic manticore fight music.
Oh, dude, this is really cool music, too.
Darn, yeah, it's really
cool
music.
Epic manticore, what we all missed.
Yeah, I will try and remember next time I set all this up for the music. Also, quick legal disclaimer, this is Killers by Incompetech. Go to Incompetech's website for more Creative Commons. Yay! we'll
shameless plug.
We'll cut that music out for now. I'll remember it next time. All right, cool. So you guys head back to the spire, yeah?
Yep.
Yeah. Cool, and when you get there, you come to the roof, and there's the commander, and he's like, "Oh, good fight. Which of you," and he looks at Reese, because the two of you are on that, "which of you felled the beast?"
Half-face.
What?
Half-face.
I take offense to that.
Good on you.
Not insulting. I point to Reese.
Cool. Yeah. He says, "Ah, excellent. You quick, bring it down to the great hall, and we'll celebrate with drink. We'll mount it to the wall, and I will give you the ring.
The one ring.
One true.
One ring.
Theo.
One ring to slow them."
Savra, the woman from before, is also on the roof. And as you guys start heading down the stairs to the Great Hall, she pulls you aside and says, "Hey, come here." And she leads you towards one of the quarters.
Cool. Sweet. Okay. Good thing I had that snack earlier. See, God. I need my energy.
Thinking don't ahead. Encourage him.
Her. Give you one gold piece. Lucky. He got lucky.
That was his feat?
So, she says to you, I wanted to tell you something. I think you should know about this. I think that you would be an excellent initiate to join us. More than initiate. You could come. You see, we are trying to master the powers of elemental air to defeat the enemies of Waterdeep. You see, there is this prophet, and she has, she has promised us great power.
What kind of power? No, go back. Who are the enemies of Waterdeep?
Oh, all of the...
Waterdeep has enemies?
Waterdeep has enemies abounding everywhere. Waterdeep for Waterdavians, something.
Oh. Okay. Make Waterdeep great again.
Make Waterdeep great again, exactly.
This is a rousing speech. Not
she's,
the
a, she's very clearly a noble who's like, her enemies include poor people.
He isn't getting roused like he wants to.
I could meet with the commander, with Thurl, and you could we can recruit you into the Feathergale Knights. And you could join us. Together we could rule Faerun.
This is a most generous offer, and one that bears considerable consideration. Remember, my wisdom is 9. Okay, just saying.
Your wisdom's 8, dear.
Yeah. Okay. Whatever. 9, 8. Same thing. I have to think this over. It's just such. I'm just so touched.
I need you to roll deception.
It's not. I'm trying to persuade her to sleep with me.
No, you're deceiving her.
That's part of it. It's okay.
I'll tell you my answer in the morning, hon.
Give you an answer in the morning.
No, so I'm rolling.
I gotta know right now. Know do you love me?
Out of hell, it was out in the morning.
Oh, I rolled really bad.
I'm not joking. I wish I could show you this. I just rolled a nat 20 for her insight check.
I'm fucking kidding. I'm That's fine.
In fact, Lily, you could come over here and look.
No, it's fine. I kind of don't really believe you. It's fine.
Come out here and look.
Nope. All right. Fine.
She doesn't want to believe you. She wants to stay in this.
If she comes
way,
and looks, does
you.
She get the 20?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, that's how the rules work.
What do you mean? Why would you not? Yeah. The power of elemental air is everything. Why would you deny it?
I don't know enough. You haven't told me. What kind of power are we talking about here? I need more information. I want to make an informed decision. Yeah.
She doesn't.
That is really true. I do really want more information about what kind of power I can get.
Okay, roll persuasion. At this point, you're persuading her.
I'm kind of giving up on like getting together with this chick, but I'm like, what kind of power is she talking about? Like, this
she's
is
all sorts of crazy.
Shit.
Don't stick your
okay
in crazy.
Yeah, they have diseases. Trust me.
Alright, so you're able to dissuade her from, like, she was starting to get, like, she was gonna, like,
she was not gonna
be
fight.
Okay. She was gonna not be
fight.
Cool with this.
I'm a fighter,
but she's like, oh,
not a fighter.
I will speak to Thurl, and he can better tell you, he can convince you of the power of elemental air.
I would love that, and that is honestly true.
Meanwhile,
cloak, I respect him.
Meanwhile, Thurl has led the rest of you back down to the Great Hall, and he's got like three or four knights like trying to mount the Manticore head. Like, they're clearly
what are they doing to the Manticore head?
That's illegal.
To mount it on the wall.
Come on, guys.
That's geometrically unlikely.
And they're clearly gonna have to bring a contractor in here later to actually do this, and everyone's starting to drink and be merry, and they're like, "Defeat of the Manticore! This honored guest!" And he looks and he realizes he doesn't know your name.
Reese, because I have no reason to, like, you know,
Reese, our honored guest, Reese of family.
Lovine,
yeah,
a family Lovine. Has defeated the Manticore, and for that, we entrust him with, we reward him with this ring, you know, and he brings it over to you. Ah, everyone cheers and drinks some more.
I wouldn't have done it if it weren't for your fabulous knights. They really carried it the entire way.
If anybody sasses me about falling off my horse, I'm going to cast Gus to make them dribble their wine as they drink it.
Oh, that totally happens. Some of the knights are saying, oh, and Salik over there falling off his mount, and then they go to drink and they spill all over themselves.
They have a drinking problem.
And everyone laughs.
Everyone laughs. The party's going on, and you see, Lily, Savra, is gonna exit.
Savra,
S-A-V-R-A.
Got it, cool.
She's gonna come out and down to the Great Hall. Are you gonna stay up there, or are you gonna come down with her?
I'll come down with her and pretend like something happened, for sure. I, like, hit her on the butt and stuff. I'm a dick.
Oh god, are you sure you have a charisma of 15 and not 9?
She comes over and whispers something to the commander. The commander turns and is like, with a look of anger, and like whispers back to her, and then like shoos her away. And then goes and excuses himself for a little while.
What happened?
Are you talking to me?
Yeah, I turn and say, what
happened?
Okay,
cool. She wasn't my type.
You mean you're a quick shot?
She blonde? No, I'm asking Jake, is she blonde?
Is she blonde?
Give me that gold back!
That was bad.
Give me that back!
She is...
He's already back! He was gone for like 3 minutes.
No, I'll tell you guys what really happened. I just want to know if she's blonde, because then I'm going to be not into it.
She's not blonde.
Oh, all right, yeah. She was my type, but it's cool. And then I tell you guys what happened. I was like, dude, honestly, she started talking, and she was totally crazy. Those are the ones that always have diseases, so I just...
Avian flu.
Yeah, exactly. Like exactly. Crazy. I just hang out with all these animals all the time.
B, give me my gold back.
Mine.
Give me that back.
Although he didn't technically crash and burn, which was your exact phrasing. Fine.
It could have happened. But
slides
I still
across
it.
The table.
No, I tell you guys like what she was saying. I was like, she was going on about like Waterdeep having all these enemies and like their little cult thing bringing about like a new era of prosperity with like some magic power and shit. It was creepy. I got out of that place.
Era.
Yeah, who's ever heard of making deals with elemental creatures and getting powers?
Exactly. That shit is ridiculous.
Completely made up. Doesn't
happen.
And
you know what? She's not
even
in a guild.
Did they say elemental air?
Yeah, she did, actually. Hi, were you listening?
I want to talk to these people. That's a pyramid scheme I can get behind.
Well, I told her that I was interested because she told me to join, and she wasn't convinced that I wanted to join because I don't really want to join. Getting confused. Confusing myself by telling the story to you guys. But, yeah, she said the commander will tell me about whatever powers they're going to get, and I was, you know, come down to here.
The man she whispered to immediately, who looked immediately pissed off and wandered off on his own.
What? He looked... Wait, they talked? What? I was... What? I didn't see that.
So, at this point, an initiate is going to come down. And he says, and he, because you guys are, like, kind of huddled, because you guys are talking. He says, the commander would like to see you in his quarters.
Oh, shit, it's that same guy.
Is that all of us, or just him? Is what I say.
All of you.
Okay.
Can we, like, roll in?
Like, the way this invitation was presented.
Yeah. What are you rolling inside on? Like, he's just asking.
On him being fucking weird. Is he, like, leading us into a trap?
He's fucking creepy.
Yeah.
I like to detect creep.
Theo, you can roll some insight.
Cool.
What are you trying to determine?
Whether or not the initiate is all like, haha, trap is awaiting.
Gotcha.
Would the initiate even know?
That five.
I don't know anything.
He's just really off-putting. He just...
Okay, cool.
We established earlier, this dude looks weird.
and he's sort of...
Awkward.
He's, like, floating, like he's being caught by some unseen and unfelt breeze.
Wait, what?
Like, hit that in was the new. Face with a hot shovel. Ugly.
So, controlled by something else.
Airbender.
Chinless. Or that.
All right, cool. I'm like, great, let's see the commander. Like, this is awesome. I love that guy. Love
looks
his
like he could use a tube sock as a freaking ski man. He's unfortunate.
Is he guiding us to the commander, or are we just
going
to walk?
Yes, he's going to lead you guys up the stairs. Cause...
Cool. We follow.
Okay. If he's not paying attention, I'm going to cast True Strike on myself.
It only lasts 6 seconds, Kyle.
6 seconds? Ah, damn, never mind. That lasted a lot longer. So...
Nope, one round.
On the way out, you see there's a couple initiates huddled around, like, a pot of soup that didn't all get eaten, and there's, like, steam coming up, and they're all, like, taking turns going, in front of it, and the next thing is,
do they look, like, scrawny, like they're not being fed?
They're thin, but they're not scrawny. They look, you know, they're fed. They don't look malnourished. They appear to be, rather than, smelling, some of them, it's not all nose, some of them, like, they're taking deep breaths of the steam.
Yeah, you realize that these are air people, and they're probably thinking that if they inhale it, it's better than eating it.
These guys are weird.
You know.
Yeah, maybe I don't like this place. It's getting fucking weird, despite the cool cloaks and sweet griffins.
Creepy doll music is going to start playing.
Yeah, that's what I feel.
Wish I had that one on
cue. We're in their house.
We're going to hit a cliffhanger soon. It's going to be awful.
Maybe it's just soup, guys, and it's really smelly. It smells delicious.
So he leads you guys up to the quarters of the commander. And the commander's, when you come in, he's sitting at a desk, you know, away. In
the room.
And you guys funnel in, and the initiate closes the door behind you. And he says, "So I hear Savra let you in on our little secret."
Well.
Let us in on what now?
It's what I just told you. The shit I just told you.
I know what I'm saying. Oh, what?
She just let him in, then you let us in.
Well.
That's accurate.
You see, this leaves me in an awkward position. You can either commit yourselves wholeheartedly to the powers of elemental air, or I won't be able to let you leave.
Well, I want to hear what more about those powers.
Well, what if we're already in a committed elemental relationship?
Are you polyentimous, elementalist?
But I don't even like flying. I almost threw up.
Oh yeah, I forgot you had to hug onto that thing, like, right by yourself.
Yeah. And then it caught you. I didn't do that. It did
the whole time.
Yeah, I didn't even notice. You don't weigh
much. I just want to get him talking about, like, the cool shit that their order will get from this elemental power.
So
like,
that's my elemental
goal.
Plane of air, right?
Yeah. This is very clearly not normal elemental air power. This is, like, Salik, you in particular know this. This is, like, evil elemental air power.
I have normal elemental air power.
Right. And he says the cult of howling hatred introduced themselves to us recently, and they have shown us secrets and powers.
Called it.
They've shown us secrets and powers that we could only imagine before.
Like what?
Do I know about them?
Okay. While he's speaking, can I grab like Eridan's shoulder and just kind of like poke him really quick and be like, "So I have a not good but kind of good plan. If push comes to shove, I might say just go and do a thing, and then we just run. Got it?
Will it involve hurting this guy?
Not if we're lucky.
What if I want to hurt him?
What if we just roll?
Then you maybe want plan C to
happen. Storm to the power. Those who venerate elemental air gain the power to. I'm talking in the background. Go ahead.
extra power.
Can I make a check to see what I know about the cult of howling hatred? Which
yeah,
is
you
just
can give
bad,
me a
bad
history.
Marketing.
History roll.
Yeah, awful marketing.
15.
As soon as this cult of howling hatred, you're like, I've totally heard of that. And you remember a symbol. That comes to mind. Give me one moment.
One of the four that used to be part of our interface.
A symbol.
Ooh.
Oh my god, Alex, we're watching
this isn't the
right
clip
now.
Art you're looking for.
But you
Flashback,
remember them from maybe. Like a history book. They existed thousands of years ago and died out they belonged to some, you know, they followed some elemental prince, and that prince faded into existence for a while, and the cult faded away.
The Order of the Six Winds fought them back in the day.
Yeah, exactly.
Lily. Air, walk with me.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, cool. Got it.
And he goes on, you know,
so they're
like,
bad news.
It gives us the power to punish those who have wronged us. You know, power is a means to an end. Destruction for its own sake isn't worth it. But destruction as the expression of personal freedom to earn things wrongfully denied. He's going on.
Yeah.
Trying to convince you guys.
I
lean over to Eridan. I say we just book it on three. These guys ain't bad news.
I think one has a plan to do that.
Okay, good.
I'm totally, like, wrapped up. Because I'm trying to give this guy my full attention, and that is very difficult for me.
Okay.
I am completely unaware of everything going on.
Gonna very gently reach forward and kind of put a hand on Theo's shoulder, say, we appreciate your offer, but really, what we really need
to
try
to
think a bit about... No. Well,
oh,
really,
my, look at the sun.
Really, there's something that I'm hung up on, and, like, mid-sentence... I'm going to cast Darkness Centered on him and then, like, just grab, pull on Theo's shoulder and start booking it down the stairs behind us.
What is Darkness?
Book it!
It's
dark.
It's magical darkness, so it's actually, like, complete pitch black unless you have a special kind of dark vision you can't see through it.
I cast No Parents.
Wait. was I right? I was right in front of this guy, right?
Yeah, you were probably closest.
Okay,
yeah.
So magical darkness happened. I'm a little bit scared of the dark, but it's fine. He's like right in front of me, right? The commander?
Well, he was.
I want to try to reach and grab his cloak. He's so nice. I
really
like it.
It's on him, like.
Yeah, but it's got those little clippy pauldron things. I bet I could still get it.
It's also pitch black now, so you have disadvantage.
Yeah, but I know he's right in front of me, so I can just I'm just gonna reach forward.
Disadvantage, dexterity check.
Not my best.
I want to believe.
Oh, no!
Oh.
You reach out and you, like, grab a big ol' handful of, like, pens.
Damn it! Okay.
I guess feathers, right?
Oh, yeah. Like,
quills.
Damn it.
Now, granted, it doesn't silence him or anything, but no light can pierce it. It's just dark.
Okay.
For 15 feet in every direction.
I definitely scream. I'm like, ah, like, what? Like,
and pull back, and I just pull on your collar and start booking it down the stairs.
I'm like, no, wait, shiny cloak.
Burrow is ditching this place as soon as that darkness spawns. I don't like air people or they're damn hippogriffs.
So as soon as you guys go out the door, there are two Feathergale knights who are standing on either side of the door. And when you burst out of the door quickly, because the commander's shouting, like, seize them, you know, and they're gonna turn to attack you guys. Are you guys gonna try and run past? Or you are on floor 3. Here, I can show you real quick.
Is there a window on this floor?
There are indeed.
Everyone hold up the reach jump.
That's what I'm thinking, honestly.
You guys are on level 3. You were just in room S10 there.
And remember that the ground is not below us. It is. It's not like at the ground level. It is 100 feet below that or something.
Yeah. And then some, it's down into the canyon, yeah.
That's like 30 feet fall. That's
Reese and I would be fine.
Yeah. Now with my new ring.
Here we go.
I don't know.
So if I'm the first one out, if I'm the first one out, they say us.
Pardon?
He's like, seize them.
He's like, seize them! Don't let them escape!
He doesn't know we're running. Yeah, he does.
You cast it, darkness.
Well, we're just doing it because we don't like the light. It hurts.
Sorry, I hate it when it does that.
It's just uncomfortably bright.
One wand.
Who's the first out the door?
Me. Very likely me.
He did. He was the one casting the spell. He probably didn't know what was going to happen.
I'm going to cast Gust at one of them.
Okay, to try and knock him back.
Yeah, let me...
Are we initiative, or are we just real-time?
We're going to do this real-time for a little bit, because if we do this in initiative, you'll all die.
Oh, then I want to throw the pens I grabbed at the other guy.
Oh. All right, so Gus knocks the guy back. Yeah, so I'm not going to roll his save. You knock that guy back, because you take him, by surprise. And you guys are going to book it for the stairs.
Hey, what about my pen attack?
The other guy goes, pulls out his sword. Pulls out his sword.
It ruins his cloak.
Yeah, it totally ruins his cloak. There's ink on it now.
So
that's what you get for wearing white.
Downstairs. So you guys are running.
I'm going to start running down the stairs, and I'm going to cast Armor of Agathis on myself so this thick black ice starts to coat me.
Okay.
Whoa.
As you guys come down the stairs, you see that the doors to the Great Hall there are open. To show you guys once again the map, as you come down to the second floor, the doors to the Great Hall are open, and like a dozen knights are now coming towards that door because they heard his shout from above, because it's right above the Great Hall and there's windows.
Keep going down the spiral staircase. Just keep on running.
No, they're blocking the stairs.
We're on the stairs, though.
Right, you're on the stairs above them. They are now on the stairs below you. Blocking you from going further down the stairs.
You said we come through the doors and they were running towards...
I didn't say you come through the doors.
From above.
I'm telling you, I said you guys are coming from above, from level 3 down to level 2.
Got it.
They heard the shouting from above them because of the windows, and at the same time that you exited, they started to run for the stairs, then you guys are at the stairs at the same time you come down and they're coming up. Sorry if that wasn't clear before.
Faro is like, it has nothing to do about a spell's like, just don't make me run.
Look, just run into them with your ice shit.
Yeah. No, I don't have that many hit points.
I'll run forward and just be like a tank. I don't care.
No, hold on.
It's been a long day.
I got this.
One of them shouting, drop your weapons!
We don't have weapons out.
I know, but you have weapons. You have weapons. They're like, drop them, surrender. That you could see in the back of these, like, there's a dozen of these knights, and in the back there's this guy going.
I can only hear it, but I imagine straight.
Yeah, it's frozen for most of us, I'm assuming, at this point. So.
Yeah.
He's floating.
He's doing
being
his
that creepy
floating
guy
ping
from before.
He's
okay.
Look at those
knights are a CR3. There's a dozen of them.
Metagaming.
I don't like that.
Strike from heaven. Sovereign strike him down where he stands.
Wait.
So, I feel like we should hang on. We haven't hurt anybody yet.
And these seem like rational
people.
No,
they really, no. See, this is going to go badly because one of them is going to touch me.
So, we haven't hurt anybody yet, and we're like totally cut off, right?
Yeah, the stairs are cut off, yeah. I mean, you can go back up, but...
I think we're still prisoner status, not meat status, though. So I agree. That's why I'm dropping weapons, raising hands.
All right, so you throw your weapons to the ground?
Yeah, I mean, it's like on my back. I just already have my hands up. Someone's like, drop your weapons. I'm like, boom, like smack it off. It's just a quarter staff.
I'm totally disgusted by that behavior.
Theo, are you going to...
Yeah, I said I go forward.
You're going to fight?
Oh, no.
No, I'm just gonna like.
You're gonna charge at them?
Yeah. Sure.
I would like to charge as well.
Alright, cool.
I guess.
Three of them are gonna multi attack. So that's 1, 2, 3.
Shield protect me.
For Theo. Two of those hit for 7 damage each.
Okay.
Then, so that's 14 damage to you.
Understand. Writing down.
Two of those hit. Aridin, so that's another, that's 14 damage to you, Aridin.
Did any of them miss?
One missed, so 14 damage.
Okay. I can riposte that.
The one that missed?
Uh-huh.
Alright.
Yeah, I would like to expend one superiority die and make a melee weapon attack against the creature.
Okay, go ahead and do that, and then I'm going to have you guys roll initiative.
Oh boy.
We're going to die.
No, we can't do that.
We're going to die.
There's a dozen of them.
All right.
I'm not surrendering to these crazy bitches.
Jake, I presume that hits?
With
23 hits.
Cool.
God,
and
my initiative is broken. I rolled 2 both times.
Oh, okay. So that's 8 damage.
Nice.
8 damage, alright.
It's already 10:30.
God. okay. This won't go too
repose,
much longer.
Sucker.
Don't worry, Ben.
Okay.
Alright, let's see.
Ignore the second roll. I got a 2. Sorry. Right. I accidentally clicked it again. I have a 2, not an 18.
Alright. 18. Sleek's a 12. Pharaoh 16. Aaron 10. Luna 4. They have 17. Okay. Reese, you're up in that order first. Are you going to fight or are you going to drop your weapons?
I'm in the back, so I'm going to kind of like raise my hand in the air, but I'm having my other hand on my dagger, just kind of waiting for the two that were up in the top.
So you're just raising one hand.
Yeah, I'm like, okay. You know, like one hand slowly going up, and that's about it.
Okay.
Wow. But I'm preparing an attack in case two of them go down.
I'm gonna see, since the twins have kind of already barreled in, so I can like slip between whatever gap they've kind of formed in by charging in themselves, and kind of just see if I can run through the mob,
past them. Okay.
Yeah.
It's not your turn.
Well, right. That it was.
No. It's Pharaoh's. No. Pharaoh's turn. Pharaoh, I assume you're gonna keep standing there with your hands up.
Yep.
All right, cool. Do you mind if I just remove you from the initiative order?
Absolutely fine.
All right, cool. Salik.
So I see a dozen armored dudes.
Yes. Plus the initiates that are around, but they don't really seem to be that scary.
This is awesome music.
This is by Incompetech. Check it out. Creative Commons.
Yeah, we're going to die gloriously.
I'm going to surrender as well.
All right, cool. I'm going to go ahead and remove you from initiative order.
Like, there's no winning this.
Hi, Aridin.
Actually, I don't. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay.
I realize I can run back upstairs.
So you're gonna go up?
Find the nearest window and jump out of it.
Alright, so you're gonna make it up the stairs and towards, like, where your guys' quarters were, because you know that there's at least a window there. And then we'll come back to you. Aridin.
Okay.
Yes, okay. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm going to attack and hope that I hit. Do I hit?
Sorry, I don't know. No, you don't. 14 does not hit.
Oh, fuck. Sorry, Lily, I was gonna try and save you.
They're
wearing their
full... They're like as tough as we are.
Yeah.
They're in full plate.
I was gonna try and maneuvering attack, but...
Yeah, nope. Luna.
Actually, look at Salik running upwards. You genius! And I run after him.
You're also going to run up. Okay. Yeah. Cool.
I have 3 hit points. I can survive a fall.
I'm going to swing my Warhammer with 2 hands.
All no, right.
I'm going to use the Great Axe.
Cool. At the guy that Aridin was reposting, or at a guy in front of you?
Just anybody in front of me.
Anybody in front of you. All right. 14 does not hit.
Can I can do this after I've rolled. Oh, wait, no, you can't say whether or not I've hit. It says before or after rolling. It says I can use precision attack.
Okay.
So I add a d8.
Go ahead and just roll an independent d8.
Ooh, nice.
Okay, it is 20 hit?
That'll be enough. Yeah, go ahead. Now you can click for damage.
Okay, cool.
Smart choice not making that a great weapon master attack, Lily.
9 damage. All right.
And I'd like to use second wind.
Okay.
So I gain 13 hit points.
No, it's 1d10.
Oh, I thought it was 10 plus my level.
No, it's 1d10
plus my level.
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool.
Great.
Cool. Do that.
It's not that great.
Yeah. Reese.
Is there a window somewhere nearby?
Not nearby. You're in the middle of the stairs are in the center of the tower. If you want a window, you got to go back
right
up.
Back up. Yep.
All right, cool. So you're going to follow Luna and Salik.
Oh, yeah.
Cool.
Can I follow them as well?
Yeah, you can. That's fine.
Cool.
The knights, there are now 3 knights that are, like, because it's narrow, so there's a bunch of knights that can't get to you guys, but the 3 that are right in front of you each get 2 attacks. So
you're not coming through. I can't hear you.
How about now?
I can't hear you.
I'm not talking.
You just came back, too.
All right, am I back?
Can I finish my thing?
What do you mean?
Yeah.
You did your healing, and that was your whole turn.
I attacked. Oh, yeah.
All right. There are 3 knights that can get to you guys. So there's 3 attacks. Only 1 is gonna hit Theo for 7 damage. Then on Aridin.
Okay.
Again, 1 is gonna hit for 7 damage.
Ow.
They're having pretty good parity on these attacks between you two guys. I'm just gonna say Salik, Pharaoh, Reese, and Luna, because you guys all ran up. You guys can act together as one initiative group. We'll do it like that. What are you guys doing?
Sounds good.
Out the window.
Yeah, just to be certain, I'm like, this is a ring of Featherfall, right?
double check.
So clapped, mashed the window with my cane, my quarterstaff, and I am out.
So Salik just leaps out.
Yeah.
Luna, Pharaoh, and Reese.
Pharaoh's like, no! I can't do that.
Yeah. I get to the window seal. Salik, catch! And I jump at him.
He doesn't weigh anything.
What? Why?
Alright, Pharaoh and Reese.
I look out and then look down and... Right down in the hall.
You go right back down. Right back down. Yeah. Do you have your hands in the air still? Or?
Yeah.
You go back down. I'm done. Okay.
No, I tap
Pharaoh on the shoulder and I go, I got you, don't worry, and I cast Featherfall on him.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. And then push him out the window.
Yeah. There he goes. Yeah,
I start to turn around and oh!
You just hear ah!
Alright. And what about you, Reese?
I'm going to stand by the window and see if anyone else is coming out.
Make sure that I don't fall down.
Okay.
How does the Ring of Featherfall work?
Left.
It might work like this.
5 feet of falling, it activates Featherfall.
So you just pushed Pharaoh out the window.
After casting Featherfall.
Featherfall, and he goes.
Yeah, he's an arcane trickster. He can actually cast
He actually knows Featherfall. How many spells do you have left, Reese?
I have... Let me double check.
Because this is the third encounter of the day, so.
Yeah, no, but I'm given a few cantrips, which that's
okay. I'm just keep an eye on that number. Yeah.
I haven't cast any spells today besides the Featherfall I just cast.
All right, cool. Cool. Theo and Aridan.
I go first, right?
Yeah, sure.
We've been abandoned, so I'm gonna follow them.
Really? No, hang on. I go first. I have a plan.
Oh my god, Alex.
Fucking Jesus.
I have a plan, and it'll hopefully work. Okay, first I'm going to do second wind real quick. Try and regain some health.
Yep.
What level are we again? Three?
Three.
Three.
So D10 plus three.
All right, so I get 10 health back.
All right, so that's your bonus
action.
And
then I'm gonna try and hit one.
Okay.
Please, for the love of God, hit. Please, 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 please. Oh, thank God.
Okay. That'll hit.
Alright. So, I'm going to do my damage. I'm going to maneuvering attack, and I'm going to say, Theo, get the hell out of here. And now I can expend one superiority die.
Is that another bonus action?
This is my maneuver.
Oh, okay, so you can just do this. Okay, sorry. As a reminder, because it's not always clear in the way 5th edition's worded, you can only do one bonus action per turn.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's...
Oh, are there limits to maneuvers you can do in one turn?
Is it a bonus action or a reaction?
It's an action.
I think it's
a lot of them don't say what type of action they are.
A lot of them are on an attack. When you do an attack action, you can do a maneuver. So this is fine.
Right. Okay, I'm good.
We can look this up later.
It's as part of an attack.
We're good. So that's 7 plus 5 for the damage.
Okay.
And now Theo can now use its reaction to move up to half its speed without provoking opportunity attacks from the enemies.
Nice.
And then I'm going to run and use evasive footwork as my other maneuver. And when I move, I can expend one superiority die, rolling the die, adding the number to my AC until I stop moving. I'm going to run straight for the window.
Well, it's up.
So now my AC is 22.
First.
AC is 22 for the purposes of running away. Yeah. As you're running away, you can't be using your shield to block, so it's going to be 16 plus 4. It's 20.
Okay, so it's 20.
Good.
Yeah.
Okay, we run to the window.
Okay, yeah. Theo, you don't get any opportunity attacks, but Aridan, that means you're going to take all three of these opportunity attacks.
Thanks, brother!
No joke, two of them are 20s, so...
Wait. Use one of your things, Alex.
So I used all my things, Molly.
That's...
There are no things left to do.
14 more damage.
Ooh.
Fuck. So I'm below zero. All
right,
oh,
so
no, wait, no, I'm not.
No, you just healed, so you should be okay, and I can rally you.
All right.
Soon.
That was 14 damage?
Yep.
14 damage, yeah. Okay. Thank God you used that second wind, right?
Right?
Yeah. Ow!
Cool.
I am yelling at you very loudly later.
You know?
Now it's the knight's turn.
Wait, they just went.
No.
Who
the fuck attacked?
They just opportunity attacked.
That's the opportunity attack.
No, it's Theo's attack now.
Oh, it is Theo. Theo ran as a reaction, right, so it is Theo's turn.
Yeah.
You're up the stairs and sort of near the room that you guys were in before where you rested. The quarters.
Okay, I get out my 50 feet of hempen rope and I tie it to like the window latch and get ready to get me and Aridan out of there.
Okay.
Reese is right there.
Just standing at the window.
Yeah,
well, are you better at tying knots than me? Then you can do this.
He has the ring.
Yeah, he doesn't need it. We don't have a way to get down.
He can cast Feather Vault.
Oh, how many times?
One more.
Yeah, like, I tie the rope. I don't know that you do magic, and I don't care. I tie the rope.
That's so shitty. One more.
Oh, my God. Oh, the music fits. All right.
Pick your favorite.
Oh, my goodness. All right. So the knights...
Can I look out the window and see if it's possible to climb down, or is it like a...
It's pretty sheer. It's. Okay.
Yeah. I don't know how we're actually getting out of this because it goes into a ditch. There's a drawbridge.
The knights are going to chase after Aridin. There's three that'll be able to get to you, and they have multi-attacks. So that's going to be 6 attacks.
I'm still moving, aren't I?
You're running away, and they ran after you and are now attacking you.
Right. Right.
I'm still running, so my AC still applies.
Yeah. That's true. You still get hit 4 times.
They rolled 20?
21, 21, 22, 11, 17, 21.
Jesus fucking Christ.
They're knights. Right. They're pretty good at what they do. Aridin, that's 3.
Ooh, I'm haunting you later.
So Aridin, are you at 0? That's 7 times 3.
How many times does he get hit after he's at 0? Because he might just straight up be dead.
How much damage am I supposed to take? 21?
21, and then there's some more, but that'll depend whether or not you hit 0 or not.
Oh, wait. On my turn, I could have rallied. As a bonus
action. I thought you were gonna...
I thought I was too, and I forgot. Totally forgot.
So Aridin?
Mm-hmm.
Are you at 0?
I'm at negative 18.
There's no negatives in 5th edition. You hit 0 and you stop.
Okay, then I'm at 0.
Okay.
Can I pick him up?
You
Isn't
are
there
already...
a rule, like, if you go, like...
I thought he was in the same
if
room.
You...
Theo, you are well past Aridin.
But
Aridin's
you
still
said
on the
he
stairs.
Was running
right.
up to me.
Aridin and Theo each did 1 action's worth of running up. Theo's was as a reaction. Aridin's was as his action. Then on Theo's turn, Theo ran past and started tying the rope.
Okay.
So you are a good, like, 40 feet away from him. At
exactly,
point.
Yeah.
Can I Alex. Yell at Reese to go get Aridin?
You hear Aridin shout, ah!
Can I see Aridin, or...?
You see Aridin for a second at the top of the stairs, but then when Aridin falls, he slumps down and you can't see him anymore.
Okay, I, like, shout at Reese. I'm like, help me get my brother out of here, you idiot!
The rest of the knights are coming up past... past where Aridin fell, and they're saying, "Look, there they are!" and pointing into the quarters. It is now. Let's do Salik and Luna.
Salik, catch!
What is wrong with you?
Luna, give me an acrobatics check. Salik, give me a strength saving throw.
This is gonna be so great. It's gonna go so bad because I have plus 0 on this.
Oh, God.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy.
Oh, yeah.
Luna, you're like, dive out. Salik, like, reaches to catch you, and you, like, kick him in the head by accident, and he falls, and he spins that way, and you go that way, and you go... And Luna, you are now falling past Salik.
This is fine.
Pharaoh, you're falling pleasantly.
Yes. Oh, yeah, I wanted to ask, how long does Featherfall last? Are we sure it's going to last until we get to the bottom?
It's until you hit the ground, I believe.
Yeah, it lasts plenty
it's
of time.
Not, are you sure it's not just 1 minute? Okay.
It lasts like...
Even if it's a minute, you'll hit the ground.
Yeah, duration of 1 minute, but you take no falling damage.
Yeah, you fall faster than you expect you fall still. You just don't take damage when you hit the ground.
Yeah. Reese, what are you doing?
Because you fall at like 30 feet per second still, Brandon. It's just you don't take damage.
So... There's a whole bunch of knights between me and Aridin,
yeah.
But you're a rogue.
So Alex, the rule is that, if the attack that would put you down does half your HP and overkill, you're immediately dead.
Right.
But it wasn't a single attack. Those weren't single attacks. So the first attack to knock her out, the attacks stop because they wouldn't have kept swinging.
I thought it was your full HP.
Right.
I just rolled
it. Negative, have to go to the full HP.
You're thinking
it's
of Pathfinder.
Half.
One of you.
These are gentlemen, after all.
Yeah, these are gentlemen. They're not going to hit you while you're down. The first attack that puts you down, they stop because I just rolled them all together. Cause
kill it!
Anyway, Reese.
Is Theo out the window? Is Theo standing at the window? What's going on?
I'm trying to go back and get my brother.
Tying a rope at the base of the window.
I finished that. Come on.
It's not your next. It's not your turn again yet, Theo. That's what you were doing at the end of your last turn. Reese.
I step up onto the windowsill. And I'm watching, like, I'm ready to jump out if something gets bad. I'm really not inclined to go and save Aridin and kill myself in the
process.
So,
ready to action to jump out of the window if...
if they just come straight at me.
Okay.
Kyle, you can disengage as a bonus action, use your move action, and then move back and not take any attack of opportunities because rogue bullshit.
But there are knights between me and Aridin, is what Jake said.
Yeah. That is correct. Some came up past Aridin. All right, Theo, now it is your turn. Reese is standing in the window looking like he's ready to jump.
Yeah.
The only thing I have to do is get Aridin. Like, I'm going to go try to pick him up.
So you're going to run towards Aridin. There are knights in the way.
Are they all up the stairs and then leaving the bottom stairs unguarded?
There are some there's some on the stairs dealing with Aridin's body. Aridin, because he's not dead. And there are some past the stairs, probably like six or so have come past the stairs and are now coming towards the room you guys are in.
Leave me!
I'm not leaving you.
And they're shouting, drop your sword! Drop your sword! Drop your weapons! Yeah. Surrender to the power of elemental air!
It might be a good idea to drop your weapon.
Doesn't make any sense.
That we're getting our ass kicked by 12 knights?
No, not that. Reese is a fucking pansy bullshitter. I hate that.
Are you waiting for us?
You won't help me save my brother's life. You're a dick. I hate you now. So, God, but I'm probably going to die, but I'm going to go try to pick him up.
You're going to run past these six knights.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Here, come on, brother. Excuse me.
All right. One, two, three, four, five, six. Your AC is 16. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 of those hit you because they each take an opportunity attack against you. 4 times 7 is 28.
Bye, Theo.
Do you have 28 hit points?
Yeah.
Okay. You're you got to run past, and one of them hits you, and the other knocks you out.
At least scream something dramatic as you go down.
I was like, brother!
And one cuts you pretty bad in the back, and the other hits you in the back of the head, and you fall down.
You guys are all dicks.
Reese, seeing this...
they're not gentlemen, and they're not in a guild. I should have known better.
Seeing this, the three of them go down to pick up Theo. The other three turn to come towards you, Reese.
Yeah, I say, thanks for greeting! Like, drop out the window.
Okay, and as you jump out the window, you know that sometimes a ring of feather fall takes about 5 seconds, or okay. 5 feet, right? You start to fall, and you're like, I'll be fine!
I immediately regret this.
I'll be fine! You're not slowing down.
I cast Featherfall.
All right. And that's where we're going to call it for this week, at that lovely cliffhanger.
We made it two sessions.
Yeah, I
know. We'll survive the fall, because doing math, if we're on the third floor, mathematically, it can't do 30 damage.
Let me remind you, with this picture of the Sighing Valley, that Feathergale Spire is on top of a very tall rock that protrudes out of the canyon.
Yeah, it's fine.
We're falling hundreds of feet. Yeah.
Like I said, it's fine.
All right, so
we are ending this with our fakes literally up in the air. Yeah.
Well, three of us are fine.
I'm on the ground.
Fine.
For anyone watching, please
slam into the side of the building.
Leave a comment. Tell us what you think.
Please vote who you want to survive.
Who you want to survive. Text now. Lines are open. comment. Tell me. Tell me what you liked. What you didn't like. What you'd like to see coming up and change. Each of you players. Tisk, that only like one of you did this last week or two of you did this last week. Message me one thing you liked and one thing you didn't like. About the session, message me privately with those.
Viewers also message Justin for that.
Viewers, totally. If you can comment on the thing if you want. If you don't want to comment, you want to do privately, you can message the Jetson Academy page. We'll take a look and tell us what you liked, what you didn't like, and we can work on it. We can make it change. We can make it what you want. Cool. And with that, we're going to call it quits. Bye, everybody. Thanks for watching.
Bye.